clown show. Oh yeah, here we go with another dope episode to let you know we tickle your funny bone 3 days out the week. Morris Media, we're bringing heat. I speak doggy dog, the nigga keep it street, the funniest motherfucker you ever gonna meet. We got Nikki Pam, goddamn she fine, the finest motherfucker in the Soul Train line. We got Kentucky, yeah, keeping it 100 with the word of the day. Now who's that girl that's precious in the building? Now what the pussy do? Cause it's your body that I'm feeling. Now DJ Ron C, hit him with a dope mix, reppin' Linwood Strong, hey Speedy. And last but not least, we got my homegirl P running things and moving things.
It's a rollout show.
Roll out.
We got Kente. No, we don't. We don't have Kente.
Did you pray to me today?
Hey, shit, can you hear yourself?
Who the fuck
is on the board?
Who's on the board?
Oh, I'm sorry, Sky. Who is fucking up in the... Oh, light skin. They changed spots.
We love you, Sky.
We love you, Sky. At least that's what it told us to say, that you're doing a great job.
Right.
We just got a text. It is the rollout show.
Wait,
right now.
Speedy, now you're going to call. Oh, Kente. Where's Kente? Where's Vanessa?
Yeah, I see
people
that.
People float in and out of rollout show. We're a rotating...
We are a floater show. The only motherfuckers that stay,
these two seats right here,
these seats will be here. These two motherfuckers is here.
What about me, motherfucker?
These three motherfuckers are here. I'm sorry, Ron. These four motherfuckers are here. I'm sorry, Scott. These five motherfuckers are here. Mia, my bad. These six motherfuckers are here. These two motherfuckers, hey. These are option seats. Motherfuckers is option. Anytime you see a nigga on this side, they ain't gonna be alone.
Musical comics up in this moment.
Unless a motherfucker sit in this seat or this seat, they ain't gonna be alone. These headphones don't even work. Mic ain't on. Right. It is the Rollout Show right here. Morris Media. It's your boy Speed Dog, your dog in the building. It is now time for... Thank you, Ronnie. Ooh. That nigga was banging today.
Sure,
I mean, he banged every
Shout
day.
Out to that Mary J. Blige.
Yeah.
I didn't know she had that many hits.
Affirmation of the day.
Come and talk to Speedy. He really wants to meet you, girl. He has an affirmation for you.
All right, bitch, get in there.
Oh, come and talk to Speedy. He has an affirmation for you. I want to brighten up your day.
You know we can't do that, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, move your titties. Move your titties. I like when you say he's just eating. What's your name?
He's eating.
There it is. On you, right. Bitch.
Oh, wow. I expect that.
Yeah, I knew you wouldn't. It's Christmas. Just a little something. Funny shit gets through the day. Ain't nothing. Nobody texts faster than a pissed off woman.
Isn't that the truth?
You motherfuckers, when you hot, you right in here, nigga, bitch. I'm with some mother.
And then you be motherfuckers sentences. Act like you didn't get it.
And now with the voice command, you could just yes. Motherfucking do it. You can just talk to your but phone and it'll text.
You have to proofread it though, because sometimes you be like, nigga, I said that. Eat my dick. No. Delete. But you didn't already sit the motherfucker. God damn.
So true.
You try to edit on the fly. I didn't mean. The other part, but fuck you.
Speedy has a bit. Well, I made him do this bit about when you talking to the phone, because I cannot.
I don't know what it.
Especially your phone, like.
Nigga, you'll do like this.
Speedy
okay.
Has built in DRC.
No, it don't work, because you ever do this shit? Okay, I know what I'm saying. I'm tell Pam, poet is stupid. Okay, whatever. Fuck!
Yes. I do that.
Oh, gate. And then they say open hate. Oh, hate. I don't hate you. I said open gate, bitch. And you got to text back. I don't hate you. I just I love you, mama.
That is so true.
This shit is wild. So you, and you get and Pam
freeze up. Nigga, I freeze up.
Pam act like she just bought a phone. She right here. Nigga, the speaker is down there. She going. Speedy, I'm here. Bitch, you are in the ear part.
Speedy said, Pam, the speaker's at the bottom. Oh, my bad.
Now she like this. I'll be outside.
I don't know why I do that. It's like something I cannot do. I totally freeze up.
Yeah, you gotta learn that shit.
Oh, God,
but yeah, when y'all pissed off, you motherfuckers text y'all ass off. Them motherfuckers be right here.
And then you guys take.
So did you receive a pissed off text? lately?
Mm-hmm. And most dudes, we ignore the shit. We nigga, I ain't got
it's
time to read
so
that.
It's so annoying.
Once you get,
that's
once
the
you
worst
text,
when you ignore.
When you when you text past the third paragraph, nigga, I'm not for the read all.
Yeah, that's you.
No, I'm not for the thumb.
I put my heart and soul into
shit,
that
bitch.
Text.
Mm-mm. I'm going to hit you with, okay.
Yeah, that the one word response.
If I hit you with okay, you know that don't even text me no more.
No
really?
More. And I mean O and a K.
Yeah.
Really? Okay, so if you say okay, don't
text.
It means
text. I'm done talking. I don't even want to, don't even text because I'm done talking.
Well, that's good.
What exclamation? What's it called? Exclamation? That's it.
Yeah.
The little bat.
The little bat, hilarious. The ball on the ball.
Yeah, I don't know why y'all dudes don't do that. If he do,
no, y'all don't.
Suspect.
Y'all short as fuck.
Yeah.
If a nigga texts you paragraphs, that's his bitch that texting you trying to find out. We got real phones around here that apparently we can't put on vibrate. She gonna say oops. Fuck you say oops in the middle of the show. It is almost Christmas, bitch.
Yeah, man.
Did you get your shopping yet?
No.
Ronnie, you?
No, I didn't even start, brother.
You go buy no more DJ equipment?
Nah.
I bet you gonna get some good shit from bitches, huh?
Hey! God damn.
What?
Damn!
What? I'm just saying.
Read the text, nigga. He just texted us.
Oh, my bad. Oh, I didn't.
Nigga,
I didn't
just texted us.
Yeah,
and said,
bad.
Don't say shit about the bitches.
Oh, my bad. I'm just
he
saying.
Is...
But I am having a dilemma because I can't figure out what to do, like what to get. Because I'm saying, okay,
yourself?
I don't want thing. No, him.
Oh,
get
Sean.
Sean. Okay.
All right, I'm gonna help the ladies out.
Yeah, help me out,
ladies listening to the show. Ladies out there listening to the show, you don't know what to get your man. Maybe you just met him, whatever it may be. If you've been with him for a while, don't get no socks. Don't buy no shaving cream.
Okay.
Or some underwear. Don't do that shit.
Okay. Be more imaginative.
Yeah. First, buy something that you want him. You want to see him in. So you want to. What do you want to see him with?
Well, should I say?
Oh,
we
shit.
Know he listens, but.
Hey, nigga.
I want him. I want to get him some tennis shoes.
You want to get a sneaker game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Sean, I'll talk to you.
Stop! We're not about to do that.
Nigga had a pair of, what are those? My son be doing. Nigga, when kids do that shit. I want to sock the shit out the motherfucker. I had the.
That's your probably just your kids though.
No, all kids do it. Am
really?
I right? Yeah,
kids
all the kids. Nigga, 3 years old. What are those motherfucking $500 shoes? What the fuck are you talking about? I had these shoes I got from Nordstrom. They were regular $250.
Mm-hmm.
They were on sale in Nordstrom for $79. But I know what kind of shoe they are. They ain't no Nike and no shit like that. But it's some fly shit.
Right.
Nigga, Brooklyn, dad, what are those? Hey, nigga, shut the fuck up. How about that? Some shit you're going to be wearing in a minute. How about
right,
that?
I'm going to pass them down to your ass.
So, but Sean did have on a pair of what are those? his Jordan had the ball in the wrong hand. It was a volleyball. That nigga.
Not true.
Okay, so you
we
get
not
some.
About to bash
so
my
these are the three things you do.
Okay.
Ladies, you get something you want to see your man with, in or with, wearing, whatever it may be.
Okay.
Then you got to make sure you get him something he actually likes, like the shit he likes.
Okay.
Like, whatever he's like.
Like, if he's a techie or something.
Whatever it may be. Yeah, make sure.
Electronics.
Yeah, you get something that he actually likes.
Okay.
So, if he into NFL and he don't have the NFL package.
Okay.
Go and buy that for him.
Oh, okay, I got you.
Say, baby, I got that.
Okay, got you.
That's how, then, nigga, we will fucking lose our mind.
Favorite team jersey or something? No, I mean, not jersey, but something with a team.
I don't like jerseys.
Yeah, well, not
I don't
you.
Wear jerseys
yeah, I don't wear. I can't wear another one.
Yeah,
we play ball.
Hard.
Niggas that really play ball can't wear no another dude on your back. You,
really?
No.
I don't like wearing jerseys.
But you a Kobe. You like Kobe. I mean, if I got you.
No.
I wouldn't wear it.
Wow.
Wouldn't wear.
Can I get it out? Shit, no. No,
nah, we know where you're going with that.
Kobe
really?
Girl.
Can't wear Kobe. Even though I'm a LeBron fan, and when we did the movie, they gave me some LeBron.
Yeah,
I can't wear it.
Uh-huh.
Not going to wear a LeBron jersey.
When you wore it into the office like, when y'all won the championship.
Oh, that's
saying.
Different. We won.
So I'm part of a 49er fan club.
Uh-huh.
I'm a DJ, whatever. And I went out and bought a shirt, but it didn't have nobody's name. It just had number 7. 49.
Really?
Yeah.
A T-shirt.
It had the emblem, though, right?
It had the 49er stuff on
okay.
it.
Okay.
Yeah, but I can't do it. So
no
yeah.
No nigga's name on it.
So buy some shit.
Okay.
The first one was?
Something
you
I want to
see
him in.
Yeah.
Okay,
or wear or okay. smell or whatever it may
oh,
be.
Okay.
Then something you know he likes.
He likes, like electronics or sports. Or...
And then do a throw-in.
Okay.
Like you said, like you want to give him a haircut.
How uh-huh. many gifts the nigga getting?
I hate you.
I hate it.
Balling on a budget-ass motherfucker. They don't have all that shit at 99 Cent Store. Some of you bitches shopping at the bed. Fuck y'all. So again, something you want to see in men, right. Poetess, ladies, mm-hmm. that's too young to buy other nigga shit.
Right.
Some you know he likes, or what he's into, whatever he's into, and then throw one in.
Okay. Like you said, like a shaving kit or something.
Well, I saw something for Canoe.
What do you think? Well, he don't listen.
Hiking
so.
Boots.
A beanie with a light in it.
Yeah, you have a nigga hiding.
Okay,
how
he gonna be mad? He goes night hiking. That's good for night hiking.
That's
resourceful.
Okay, ladies, resourceful. If you say the gift and all your friends and y'all laugh, don't get that.
No, he's a different
watch,
kind
do,
of
do
dude.
Do it again. Watch this. Do it again. Okay. What you gonna get him?
A beanie with a light built in. I saw it on Facebook.
Ron, see?
Okay, but if you're into hiking and camping
or
something.
I'm trying to help you, P.
That's the thing.
If you bring me, I love to hike. Let's just say I love to hike.
Okay.
And I hike at night sometime. And I pull out the box and I'm like, this bitch got me something nice. And the beanie got the light and I'm going, oof.
For you wouldn't.
No, I'm going to go, this is really, okay, cool. And but you put it on and I'm going to light it up and you'll be like, you'll look stupid. And then you're going to laugh and it's going to be a joke. And you're going to be like, now ask me what I got you after you gave me light with the beanie.
What did you give me?
I'm going to get it for you tomorrow. You ain't getting the shit I got you today, bitch. You ain't getting this good shit. You got me a beanie with a light on it. What am I?
But number two was something that he's into. Her man is into hiking. Mine is into electronics.
Okay, so you got to do three then. So that's the into one.
So that was two for her.
I think he would like, what do you call it for men that, you know, like the lotions and stuff for the beard and just.
Oh, my God.
So the grooming kit, that's okay. What I thought it was.
That's your throw-in. That's your throw-in.
That's a throw-in gift because I missed that this morning.
That's a throw-in.
Because,
see, that shit I can get anytime I want. I just don't go get it. So you throw that one in. Now, what are you going to get him that you want to see him in, see him wear, smell like, whatever it may be?
Okay, so that's the thoughtful one.
Yeah, this is when you got to know him.
I fucking hate.
What do you want to see him in that you think this will look fly on my man? Or. Canoe.
Naked? Just saying.
Midriff? You get him a midriff. Come on, P.
But have you been stressing it like me or you probably
no,
not?
I have
I know
not.
You have not.
We only been dating 6 months, nigga. You
nigga, this is nigga what
I'm
saying.
You ain't getting a watch.
Nigga, again, you go get the watch to get to put the ball in. Hold on. What time is it? Let me get the ball in here. I know what time it is. Six months is long enough time to get three gifts.
I'm saying if they are three gifts, they're not going to be like hell of expensive.
Yeah, the beanie kind of wrapped it.
The beanie look, from Facebook.
Yeah, you did see
he's
it on Facebook. That ain't too original.
We're just dating. So what do you get somebody that you're just
yeah,
dating?
Yeah, what is the protocol
no,
for
it's
that?
6 months. Nigga, we fucking. We ain't dating no more. You getting dick on every occasion. So we together. This is me and you against
I
the world.
I said we're still dating, so.
You fucking.
So that comes with dating.
P, you're 6 months in. You're committed.
I don't know.
You got to do more than a beanie. You gotta do more beanie and some lotion
well,
on the beard.
Well, someone said gift cards, and I said, well, maybe a gift card.
Because a gift card means I ain't had time to think about you.
Okay.
So here's a card, you go think about you. That's not cool. That could be a throw in.
I don't know what I'd like to see him in. He dresses casual, and I like him casual. I mean, otherwise, it would be a suit, and I
No, you ain't
gonna
do that.
You know.
Because then he wear that to the other bitch house, it's gonna be a problem.
Oh, yeah. No.
Where you going in my suit, nigga? Mm-mm. Yeah, that's where you put Clorox on that. Mm-mm. You ain't wearing this, motherfucker.
So the guys are saying something electronic always goes.
You always go. If they're in there in the tech stuff, you don't want to get electronic shit and the motherfucker don't know.
Now, if we were like together and I was balling, I would like to get him an upgraded system in his truck.
Oh, it's whack?
It's what?
No, speakers be making noise. You know, listen to CDs.
Oh, you
want. I'll actually.
You know how you fix that?
What?
You, okay, is a CD player?
Come on in, baby. It's in the built-in his dad.
Yeah, but there's a thing you can get that will
get him that, the attachment. So
no, yes, an attachment that you can get that'll be able to
Wi-Fi
your
phone. He your probably has that too.
No, you don't. If he did, he did it. He played it.
But he likes CDs. He actually still purchased. He likes still reading the cover.
Nigga got real to real at the house.
Hey, you want to listen to this cassette?
It's so funny. I just bought the new Prince Forever CD. And I was like, I don't know why I did that, because I was going to put it on, you know, onto my phone like I do all my music, whatever. But I put it in my CD player, and I was going somewhere the other day, and it was all like mumbled, and it was all dirty, and I was like, shit. I mean, who buys CDs, and why did I do that?
Yeah, that's what you do, Pat.
Who
and
does
you
that?
Put your big ass thumb on it.
Yeah,
so
that was dumb.
Ladies, please don't do like my wife did last year, nigga. I didn't know I could be that upset.
What did you do?
So
I know you. Did you tell us
Christmas and my birthday?
Man. I know
my
your birthday. I know that one.
Fucking worse.
Yeah.
No, I said last Christmas she bought me the As Seen on TV shit.
Oh, that's right.
Because I'll be.
Well, she knows you're into it, so that was her second one.
Nigga, no, that was her go-to.
Wow, that was her it?
Look, the egg thing?
The bacon maker?
Yeah, the bacon maker.
I don't know why he expects so much. She's a light speed. Not like that. I'm just saying. She probably was watching TV like, what do niggas like? It's say
shot fire.
I say bacon.
Maybe he like this ass scene on TV.
He is watching it.
Hi, POTUS. I don't like that.
You saw her stare through her glasses. Then she did. Oh, here, come here with this one.
No, I did not.
That's when nigga want to see you outside.
Wait, the baby opened the gate for me. She said, you about to get cussed out. I know.
At least she was pre-warned.
Right. No, I'm having a trying week, though.
How do you ease in? You ain't an easing kind of. You was like.
No, I'm having a try. Okay, the car broke again.
What?
Remember, I put it on.
Car
or if you see, I put it on Facebook like 2 days ago.
We don't follow you.
Well, anyway,
yeah,
it broke down on Fig. I was like, let me just get out and start work. That's what I put
Hey,
on
bitch. Hey, nigga.
I was like, well, at least it stopped here because this looks like
Is Figaro still there?
Yeah, I think it is.
It's
been
stroll.
That way since I was a kid.
It's gonna always be the whole stroll.
Yeah. Figaro.
Mm-hmm.
And then when crack was in, it was ridiculous.
All right, so it broke down.
And Washington, too, huh, at one point.
Well.
Washington.
So they said it was another, I think that they just be getting me, but they said it was another $3,000 or something like that, right? So I'm just going to get a new car. My mom was like, I'll just help you get a new car.
Oh,
so,
that's nice. You have parents to help you do that.
Yeah.
So we were.
I was always on my own. My parents didn't ever help me.
Your
get car
break down. Your car broke down.
No, if I needed a ride from work, sorry, you got to take the bus. They didn't. Johnny and Lucky. Oh my God.
Oh shit.
Then when I first moved here,
this is why the phone call go. Call me. You put it.
Mom, I need a ride.
Yeah, well, you still need one. Where are you trying to go? Did you call your dad?
Right. I remember when I first moved out here from the Bay, I had just finished high school. I was going to college, and my dad used to just give me $2 a day.
That'll hold
I
you.
Was like, I'm going to have to get a job. This is that bullshit.
But
that was barely enough to take the bus.
He gave you just enough to get you where you had to go.
$2 right here. This get you on the train. This how old your daddy get you on the train right here.
It's the catch 22 though, because look, POTUS, you got all of this. Like when shit fall apart, I don't even know how to comb my hair like that. Like I'm stressed out.
It did make me independent.
You're saying
it
you don't, did I got make you
yeah. My dryer broke.
Wow.
Yeah, this is some shit I ain't never wore.
Way in the back of the closet.
And then my mama like, go to the wash house. I said, what?
She said, what? The wash house?
Where everybody washes their clothes? What the fuck? So now I'm just pulling
it out. Your
I'm
underwear.
Doing this like, I think this will be okay. I didn't even want to get out the car.
You not bougie. You bougie?
She don't do laundromat.
Ghetto bougie. Just a little. Yeah. You know, I grew up in the hood, but it was over there. It was like.
I think we're about the same with that. Because
no.
I do fluff it for
me. I think Pam's a little bit more bougie. Yeah.
Pam ain't never been in a wash house. She wouldn't even know what I fuck
I do fluff and fold. I do drop my
stuff off. So Pam's ass, on the way home, speaking, you go by the fluff and fold. I have my underwear in my. I said. Pam.
They fold it, Pam?
They do everything.
Nigga,
it smells yummy.
And there's a little Japanese come out. She bring it to the car. How y'all do, Pam? Nigga, and it's folded up like this. And I said, Pam, you can't. And it was this much shit. I said, Pam, you can't. I don't watch nothing.
So all your drawers is perfect because she.
They roll it in perfect little balls.
Pam, you gotta let me know where that's at, Pam.
And it's cheaper in L.A. I heard it's 80 cents a pound. Mine is $1 a pound, but hers is 80 cents. I hear it's 80 cents a pound. So
that's sad.
It's wonderful.
You go anywhere, they have a fluff and fold.
Yeah, all the laundromats, most of them.
I don't go to laundromats. I didn't know. Because it'd be clothes all over my house. I'd be like, Catalina, you need to fold these clothes. Well, we be arguing over who's going to fold now. I wash the shit now.
Right.
But folding, yeah, so I'm
you
just
a mess. You don't fold up the clothes?
I do if I have, like, if it's a man living here, well, I'll fold. But, like, it's just us. Like, I'm not going
to
lie.
If I go to your house right now, I'm like, listen, hey.
Yeah, you might have to move towels off the couch. You might. But they clean now. Everything clean.
Just fold it up.
I am. I'm gonna start. Just, but anyway, yeah, I've been having a hard week.
Porter, so. you go to Washington, Jerry?
I do.
See,
but domestic? I fold my clothes. I mean, it takes me about an hour, hour and a half to wash all my clothes, and why? I fold them. And
oh, because you wait till the end of the week to wash?
No, I wash. I wash when I have time.
Why it take an hour? First
it takes
of all,
an hour.
Take that motherfucking base out your
mouth. Motherfucker, who are you talking?
It's 37 minutes for one and.
Right, it's it takes 30 minutes to wash, 30 minutes to dry, and a little while
somebody's at the gate.
To fold. I fold my clothes.
Uh-huh. Well, I wash all the clothes. In the house. If I don't wash, it's shit
do
piles up.
Do you fold
up.
Them too?
No. Yes, I do. But I put, like, the kids, I just like the Brooklyn shit in pile, John shit in pile, and
you
the girls.
A bunch
and,
of people
and I take it in their room and they put it up.
But some people know how to fold where you don't got to iron the shit.
That's speedy.
Yeah, it's I have that. Long. You know that thing at the Foot Locker that you fold the shirts?
Yeah.
Somebody gave me one of those for my birthday. Oh, nigga, what? Nigga, I'm here.
You like that birthday?
That's that Virgo shit.
He loves that.
No, girl, that's no, that Virgo
I, we
shit.
In the, we in Foot Locker. I was like, oh, that shit is dope. Nigga, my birthday came. That bitch slid me that shit. I said, I fucked that bitch really well.
Oh, wow.
And I'm in my room, nigga. Look.
Oh, my God.
Nigga, you open my drawer, the motherfuckers look like the Foot Locker.
Yeah. He tried to show me on the shirts and stuff. I was like,
see, I want my drawers to look like that, but I don't know perfect. How to fold like that. That's why I said if I went to the Fluff and Fold, my house would be neat. It. That's the only you problem I have with the folding. Everything else I can
well,
do.
But if you can't get the Fluff and Fold, go to, I forgot where she got it from, but it's the thing, nigga, you just lay the shirt
about,
and you go like this. Bam.
Yeah,
I would like to open
well, hold
up.
Hold on, whose hair you got? That ain't your shit.
That was the hair from the picture on Facebook.
She wearing a rollout show shirt. Girl, show it to him.
That ain't her hair, though. They ain't the rollout hair.
The hair goes with the rollout shirt.
No,
y'all
it don't.
Y'all see my shirt?
Hey, Tangie.
Buy a shirt.
Bitch.
Buy a shirt.
Bitch.
Rolloutshow.com.
That's right.
We need to start
get rid of these motherfuckers.
Pushing that
yeah,
shit,
we are.
Nigga. Push
these
that shit. The great Christmas gifts. Get your so, man
get your,
a rollout t-shirt.
Yes. Please
bitch.
Do.
So we were talking about some whole lot. Do you fold your laundry? And you do all that shit yourself? You domestic? No.
See how shirts fit. Tangie Spirit ain't never did that.
I do.
You see, did come down. She went
hard to folding and shit.
But you know what? It wasn't so bad until I had kids.
Oh.
Now I gotta wash every week, and it's like I'm like. My daughter makes like 5-6 wardrobe changes in the day. And then she invites her friends over and,
what,
they do changes.
And what kids do, they'll change clothes and that clothes they just took off, they think it's
they
dirty.
They think it's dirty.
And,
they
and you, bitch, yes. I just washed this
yes.
yesterday.
Yes. Right. And or if you got a kid like mine,
nigga,
when she want to go somewhere.
I did. I just
everything dirty. She put in her closet. And that's how she clean her room up. And I my dumb ass forget to look in the closet every time. I'm like, oh, it look nice in here. Like,
what's
the
that
closet.
Smell? Bitch, you need a stick up in there.
Tomorrow, all the clothes be back on the floor. I thought you watched this shit.
At least she's smart enough to hide it, though. My baby doesn't hide hers.
Really?
It'd just be all over the room.
Now, are you doing Christmas gifts for any for your own dude?
Yeah, where are you at with that? We were talking about that.
Are you
going to
get him something?
I'm definitely going to get him something.
You know what you're going to get?
Some gloves.
Oh, Speedy has that. The rules. Break down the rules.
I thought about one of those hats.
Yeah, you... See, that's something she wants to see him in. She got to get three things.
Okay, here's
something
the thing.
You want to see him in.
Uh-huh.
Some shit that he actually likes
into.
That he into.
Yes.
Like hers and is camping, mine is electronics.
And yes. then a throw-in.
Three gifts? How did,
hold
that's
up,
how you know.
Hold up, motherfucker. Three.
You really repping for the niggas. They get three gifts.
Ron?
Three.
But then is he going to get me three, too?
That's not the
probably
point.
Not.
That is
what?
Not the point.
That is the point. Because
most likely, we're going to
get one, but it's going to cost more than all.
Thank you. We're going to get
better.
You some really fly
okay.
ass shit.
It better, because I'm petty. I am petty.
Okay. Yeah.
So I've been saying, that one ain't for you. That was my dad's. My bad.
Right.
Okay. Here,
sorry.
All right, so here's it. Here it is. That's funny as fuck.
Very you
do you open the gifts at the same time? Or are you going to say, because if your shit is really fly, you say, no, you open yours first. Right. Or I'm open your shit first. And if it ain't right,
no, I'm gonna go first.
Bitch, I got these glasses for you. Shit you need.
So I'm gonna go first so I can assess. I'm with you. I'm gonna assess the equivalent.
So you have a whole lot of pocket. What you do, don't put names on the thing. Just know what's in them. That way,
so
if you have to switch.
Yeah, you can switch it up.
Nigga, give you some socks. You can go, oh, okay, here.
Yeah, open this one first.
So DJ Ron donated these headphones. Yo, this is fly shit. Yeah, this is fly shit. Matter of fact, he didn't even want them no more. So you got to have packages with no names.
That's right.
Just in case you need to, nigga, you gave me a rollout t-shirt. Hold on.
If you too scary to do that, buy it a smaller size, so if you don't get your right gift, you gotta take it back and exchange it, and then just don't bring it back.
Look, did you get a change? They wouldn't.
Somebody in the chat room said that Tandy's getting Mr. Dyson's sleeping bag.
Oh, that would too be a soon.
Actually, that's actually good.
Yeah, only thing though, she gonna be in the bag.
Oh,
hey, Mr. Dyson.
You know what I wanted to get Mr. Dyson? I wanted to get him. You know, you can go to Costco's and buy those boxes of fire logs that burn for 3 hours.
Tangent, he's actually outside.
I know, but those fire logs get hot.
Burning it. No.
In that charcoal grill. He said I put the coal in the grill and they keep it warm.
Logs, that's true. I mean,
so I thought I would get him a log, a box of those logs.
With a ribbon tied around.
He would be grateful.
Yeah.
Oh my
it's better
God.
Than, it's
that's cold.
It's actually better
gift.
Than the coal. Because the coal's not good
would
for
be
you.
Nice.
He either needs some logs or he needs something for that sugar. He said he
could go down there with a thermostat.
500. I don't know how it's 500.
How about a blanket?
You could take a thermostat full of cocoa down there and he'd be happy. And break it off. Like he was
fuck
cocoa. No, he would. He was in love with
he probably
you,
would. Yeah. He probably would. But I wouldn't.
But Speedy was
going to
give him, coffee maker, remember?
Yeah.
And then he was going to give it to me.
And then I got
and
a
then
call.
Wifey called and was like, So Speedy came back, picked up the
nigga,
coffee maker.
I was
maker.
Almost at home. Look, almost in, about to hit the garage opener. Where's that coffee maker? And I had to call Pete like, hey Paul, so using the coffee maker?
Just throw it
in. Not yet.
I'm finna stick up a part as well.
You
so
had
you
to take it back, nigga. No.
Yeah, re-nigga. That's what it is.
Yes, he did. So wait a minute.
You
I said,
supposed to with a deep voice say, bitch, I gave Poe the coffee maker.
Yeah.
No, I pick and choose my battle.
Balls.
I pick and choose my
you could have went and bought another one.
That's what I said. Didn't I say that?
You
better?
Did say that.
But I said, no. And then I have to make it look like the one that was fucked up. Got to take the tray out. Scuff it up a little bit. So I said, what if I'd have gave
wait
it
man,
to...
Wait a minute, hold up. You said, then I got to make it look like the one that was fucked up. So you gave Portis the one that
yeah,
was fucked up?
He had an extra coffee
up,
maker.
But I'm just saying,
yeah, it was raggedy.
It wasn't raggedy, yeah, really?
So that's why I didn't care when he came and got it back.
And she sat outside the gate. I was like,
yeah, take this raggedy mom.
Oh, you know what?
That's two violations, right?
I would have had to think hard on that if he'd have gave it to me. Should I get this motherfucker back or should I start some shit in this nigga household? You going to give me a bro coffee maker, then you going come get it back. I don't know. I might turn that. I don't know. Tell her to come get it.
That's when you know the shit. You tell that bitch come get it. Never mind. Just go on, keep that.
Why didn't you say, baby, I wanted to get you a new coffee maker?
Because we already have a new one. That was a.
So she wanted.
She had already
so
sold.
She was
one?
Selling it on
so
eBay
for $5. So see, $15. So the, she, he
the
had,
person
a, had
came
a
to get it.
Double back to get a fucking old ass coffee
for
maker $15. For $15. Because she felt she looked bad.
It took $15 worth of gas to get here from in that big ass truck.
But here's the thing. Had I gave it to Mr. Dice, I'd have had to do the same thing.
No, you wouldn't have. You would have just told her, hey, I'm sorry,
like,
I gave it away. Here's $15.
You better not go back.
I'd have been like, hey, yeah.
Mr. Dice would have said, I sold that motherfucker.
I gave it away. I'd had to find the tin it was in. Hey, anybody got that coffee maker?
Oh, my God.
So what did she think you had done with the coffee maker?
I bought it here.
So she thought it was here?
Yeah.
She wanted you to look bad.
Wow.
Okay, what are we not going to do?
Okay, I'm sorry.
All just right.
Like, and she was only selling it for $15?
Can we
stop? She couldn't say to the person, I'm sorry,
my
it's already gone.
It. Yeah, my
it's
husband
already,
took it.
I mean, if it's for sale, it's already gone. My husband sold it to somebody else. I'm so sorry. But I do have this great popcorn maker.
Uh-huh. Well, that would have made too much sense. Okay. That would have made too much sense.
That's what we would have did, y'all.
Right. All the black women in here
would have
did that.
You a fool.
Hey, we would have.
That's what we all would have did.
Right.
Who
right,
called you to
right,
come today? It wasn't me.
Right.
Ron, don't be calling motherfuckers on your own shit. Okay. You don't know when you're going to be
in. Is that what y'all do at the house when y'all get rid of some old stuff? She resells it on the internet?
Mm. Pretty much.
Sorry.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I'm just asking. I just want to know if that's what happened.
So the broke table last week.
Oh.
And the furniture.
Y'all like my rollout shirt?
I think it's amazing. It's the pink and the blue is matching. Oh,
thank you.
Phone
thank ringing. You.
What that mean? We ain't scared. Hello?
I hate you. I hate this fucking show. I don't even know why I come here on Wednesdays. I'm going to do like Ron. I'm going to start texting niggas right before the show starts. Hey, nigga, tire is flat. I was like, which tire? Oh, the spare tire. One nigga. Go put some air in the spare. That's how you know it's bullshit, nigga. Right. Oh, the visor broke on the thing. Can't block the sun to get there, so I can't do the show. So how's your mom? She good?
Yeah, it was just all checkup.
Just checkup?
Yeah.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, that's good.
House in the Heights, so I have some driveway out there.
Oh, okay.
In the truck?
Yeah.
Do you turn the music on with your mom in the car?
Yeah.
My mother would not.
My
let
mother
me turn
used
the music
to be like, turn it down, and she would touch the knob.
I don't turn it up.
No, nigga, I can't turn it. If it ain't on Kirk Franklin?
Yeah.
Then I have.
Yeah,
if I listen to anything else, she's in the car and she using her pedals, she driving. I'm like, Mama, stop. I can't. You got to slow down. Hello, Jesus. I said, we had a stoplight. What are you doing? Bitch, we already stopped. She holding on. And then so the kids get in the car, they want to hear rap.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
And my mother sitting there going, what is this shit on the radio? We turned to the gospel channel.
Right.
So we listen
that's
to
my
Kirk
dad.
Franklin. Gospel?
Yeah, no, my dad does what your mom does.
Oh, he breaking and staring.
He'll just break out into a story. Back in my day, we didn't do nothing like that. You know, see, he'll start talking about all the groups and all the shit and all the concerts he went to and all the girls he had and all the.
Oh, your daddy
story
was doing it?
Yeah, my daddy was a player. He fine. My
he's handsome.
Fine.
I saw him on Instagram.
Mm-hmm. My daddy fine. Mm-hmm. Especially back
can
in the day.
Somebody say that about your daddy? Can they?
Yeah, it's cool.
It's cool. It's cool.
Now, my mama, I would
get seen your daddy too. Your daddy
like, if a man be like, oh, your mama fine, I'd be like, don't play. Yeah, and my mama a little lonely right now, so I'm scared. Like, mama, don't bring nobody home. I will beat their ass. Like, stay strong.
Yeah, when my mother was dating, so, I hated that shit.
Yeah.
Because niggas always try to get to know me. How you doing? Look, man, is my mama here? Like, the dude she had married, he passed away, but the dude she had married, I ain't know his name for like the first 2-3 years.
Wow.
I was like, is my mama here?
That's wrong.
Hey, how you doing, Speedy? She upstairs. You want me to go get her? It's cool.
So how the comedy thing?
It's my man, please.
This conversation.
It's too late to get to know me, nigga. I'm grown already.
So what you like to do?
A lot of shit. And not with you. How about that? I ain't got time to know a new nigga. I ain't.
Yeah.
I ain't got time to invest into that. I don't know about you. Yeah. You mean the new, is your dad date or your dad?
Oh, yeah. All my girlfriends were digging my dad.
Whoa. Really?
Yeah.
Like they
and would you have had a problem if any of them dated him?
No, as long as they don't mess over him, we cool.
Wow.
Well, he old.
That
you
much
know
younger?
Yeah. I don't care. But
he's a sugar daddy.
But he's 75 and like they were like... 52.
Hold on.
55.
My mama's 75. What's that?
My daddy's 70. That's, my daddy's
so it's
older
different
than your daddy.
Yeah, it's different, you know, but...
He got all his faculties, everything's good?
Everything is good. Well, I don't know about that, because I ain't in it all that, but...
Oh,
but
oh,
nigga,
you yeah know, so I mean... But,
I'm asking your daddy fucking... Does dick work?
You probably would. I wouldn't be surprised.
I don't know about that, but I do know that his brain, and he still got that, you know, player thing. You know, he come in there and they'd be in the room and he'd say, yeah, you know, that one, she look good, yeah.
Yeah, when you old, you can just blur the shit out.
A little bitch hit and growing up.
Yeah.
Yeah, out of all the people, my daddy will love you, Tangy. You be see his favorite. He come sit next to you. Mm-hmm. He'd be like, there you go, come here, I'm gonna go sit next to Tangy.
He ain't even trying to hide it.
Hey,
he gonna go over here and fuck Tangy. How you doing?
Oh, wow.
Hey,
you know,
he hit you with some shit you like. You know I'm homeless.
Stupid.
I'm really cold out in these streets, baby. Because Tangy, easy. All you got to hit Tangy with some sympathy.
Some heartfelt shit.
Yeah.
You got to hit it from the heart.
I ain't got my check this week. Oh, you don't have a check? Nah. Kamira don't really take care of me like she's supposed to. She won't fold none of my shit.
Yeah, my daddy want me to be in shape like Tangy. That's why I know. His ex-wife was like, in shape, like 50 years old, going to ballet class. And
oh, she wanted up.
Every time my daddy see me, he look disappointed. What you talking about?
Oh, wow.
No, that nigga open the door like, oh, come here. You just going to stay like that.
Damn.
Does it fuck with your self-esteem?
He even get on my daughter. Kayla be like, I'm going
to my father used to do that to me, too.
Really?
Yeah, what did he fat shame me?
What did he say?
Wow.
That's not.
Nah.
Gaining weight, huh? Got McDonald's and Kentucky Fried in the car bag.
Oh, don't have that in the bag. Yeah, my daddy was like, "Come here, what you doing with this shit?" Don't make no really? Damn sense. Wow. You gonna keep getting bigger. Just, I'm telling you, he be on my head. Like, he'll call and talk shit and be like, how you doing? I'll be like, I'm fine talking about you. I was calling your heart. I'll be like, daddy. Oh, shit. I'll be like, oh, Joe, you asshole. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
Oh,
shit. Oh, shit, I'm crying.
No.
Bitch, I ain't talking to you. I'm talking to your heart. Sound like you're fluttering right now.
Oh,
you gotta bring your daddy up here.
Oh, please, no. He needs to be on this show.
You gotta bring your daddy here. That shit is absolutely hilarious. I'd have got in shape right then. What you doing? Running, nigga. Shit. Want no more calls from your ass.
That's him, I promise.
What are you gonna get him from Christmas?
You know what he got me for my birthday last year? What? One of those weak people to send the food to your house so you can
to have a diet
like
healthy
diet
meal.
Box, yeah, the box.
Blue apron. So, look, yes.
This. Daddy, what you get me for Christmas? Ding dong. Go and get
what
the dough.
Supposed
get the
to
dough.
Be eating. This is what you're supposed to be eating.
Just, oh, wow.
I'm like, damn.
Did you eat it?
Well, not well, a couple of months at least? I mean, or was it a week?
No, he cheap. You know, like 2 weeks. Like, I'm that's going
like,
to
help. That's going to help. That ain't going to help.
Like, nigga, you need to sponsor me if that's the case.
Did you eat the food?
No, I didn't. I was very, you know, I don't tell him, but I be mad. Like, he disrespected me. I'm cute, damn it.
Yes.
I think the joke of the day. How you doing? I'm fine. Not you, your heart.
Yes. Yes.
I can't wait to use that motherfucker. Yes. Your daddy a genius.
He is. He really is.
I mean, this nigga is a comedy writer. This nigga is fire.
That's what he always, he got advice for all of us. He can't remember, Speedy, what you need to do with this show is up. He would tell us everything.
Oh, right. He got to come on.
He wanted him.
Yeah.
He, man,
and your dad did that to you, B?
Yeah.
Oh.
First my mom, was, too. If she
you
see,
think?
If
nigga, she
noticed,
did put you in the closet, motherfucker.
If she notice I'm picking up extra weight, she'll say something. She'll say it to anybody that's picking
does she
up
blurt
weight.
It out? She laughs
yeah,
it out?
Yeah, no, she... pretty straightforward.
Nigga,
what
fat.
A word she get that from.
Yeah.
Damn, you getting fat.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Yeah.
My daddy wouldn't say it, but my mother would say it. She'd look at me, and especially after I had the baby, just, you gonna wear that?
Like some smell.
Yeah. Yeah.
You all got that.
And I used to tell her, mother, when you say that, it doesn't make me feel good, and that doesn't make me want to work out.
Right.
It doesn't. It
and
just makes me
said,
be like, whatever. Well, you need to do something.
Mm-hmm.
I did not send you out here to be looking like that.
That's one of my daddy lines. Me and your mama fine.
Right.
We didn't raise you like that.
Said me and your mama is fine.
Right.
Oh, God. Right.
Right. Oh, shit.
Call, yes. See how you was doing. I'm fine. Not you, bitch. No. Gotta use that,
that
one, fans. Use that motherfucker
day.
Right there. That shit is absolutely. Yeah. I'd have never thought of that.
But the thing is, you're beautiful, and like Speedy would hit you. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Wow. Really?
Yeah. Speedy would have hit that by now.
No, he would have
hit
tried. Flavor all day. If he didn't want married to the white girl, seriously.
Wow. You guys are something else.
We're going to go to break. I know my phone's going to ring in just a minute. This might be my last show here, so I want to thank everybody who supported us. And you have fucked it up.
I'm just saying. I mean, you was flavor.
And all the fans love Kamara.
Love. I don't think I've ever seen one negative comment about you. The rest of us, hell yeah, you, all of us. Mm. But yeah, you never.
Which gonna still you. Call on you, Tangie.
Who's who? That?
What's her name?
Tangie?
Yeah.
Was she the what?
Tantizi hate her. She hate me.
Oh.
Why is Speedy still there? Bitches, you see me. I'm in the logo, bitch. I'm here. When you in the logo, that means you're here.
So and when you good, when you ain't good with Tantizi, you ain't good with yeah. Okay, okay.
Because she never have a bad thing to say about you.
Never.
Tantizi has never changed her mind about nobody.
Right.
Oh, if she didn't like you day one, she don't like you right now.
Yeah.
Shout out to
what she should be calling
you.
Yeah, I appreciate that. She's in a chat room, that's for sure. Yeah, because she followed me. She followed me on Instagram.
She like you.
See, yeah,
she
yeah, like I like you too, Tantizi.
The two
she
people
is.
She never really had a problem with you and Ray for some reason. She love you too.
Oh, well, Aries. Maybe she love Aries. Right, Aries?
That's it. I don't know.
Maybe she like girls.
Okay, that was funny. Right.
Okay, okay, that's okay.
Took me a minute. Yeah. Ooh, wait, I got it. Okay.
Okay, okay, okay.
Yeah, I'm good. Her daddy great, but I'm good. It is the Rollout Show. Again, if you're looking for gifts for your significant other.
Yeah,
now, ladies.
Call in and give us suggestions.
I gave you what guys want.
Mm-hmm.
I need to hear from the ladies what you're looking for.
What's the number? I don't see the number.
It's right there. Oh.
That's not
the way we do it. 323-293-3375. What are ladies look? What are the three things or what kind of gifts should you look to or were you looking to receive?
Yeah.
You know what? I don't know. This might sound weird, but I don't expect any gifts. And when I do get them, they're.
It makes it that
plus,
much better.
But
yeah.
I'm not.
You know what's gonna happen?
Anything.
They gonna buy you a phone case.
I'm gonna pull this.
I took that approach with my baby daddy. That's what. So when he come over with something, I'll be like, "Thank you."
Right. Yeah.
Have a little
so he didn't come with nothing.
Yeah, I don't Thank expect you. Nothing. Okay. But
so again, not, you're not really.
No, I'm not.
I agree. I'm not expecting anything either. But if I get something, I would like for it to be something that he thought about.
See
even,
what I mean?
Even
what
if it's just yeah. a rock.
But you know that I you like rocks.
Even if
a
it's
rock?
Just, you know, I like Jeez. Stones. If it's just, you know, Tangie, I saw this on the beach and it made me.
No, she don't. She don't want no rock. Don't give her no rock. Just in case he listening. Don't give her a rock.
I don't really
but you
want
know what?
A rock.
Whenever,
but if it's something he thought about, you know,
that's
got
what
some
I
meaning behind it.
Whenever my friends go abroad, I do ask them to bring me back a rock. From
me
the
too.
Land, from the land
me
or
too.
Sand or
you
dirt
niggas,
from the land.
Is it? That's nigga. I probably ran into either one of you.
I'd
have bored Teddy. I'd have been like, "Look here, baby. I'd have found this motherfucker in front of your yard. I found this on the shore of Thailand."
Oh my God! You brought this back for
yes,
me.
Yes, I did. And it says,
"Thank you."
I think it says, "Look at the bottom. It says Tangie."
I'd have been her homegirl behind her, like.
Bitch.
I'm taking this bitch. I'm about to tell her. Tangie, come on over here.
But see, I'd have knew you was like that. I'd have been like, Tangie, come here. So, hey, come here. Go, open in your room. Just go. Why are you looking at us?
Why are you looking at us?
Go in the room and open the rock. I mean, the bag.
My ex, you know what he used to bring me? He used to bring me zingers. Which, of course, made me fat.
What is that?
The cupcake thing?
Yes, because he knew, even though I told him, you know,
zingers
I don't need to be
good.
Eating sugar, but I love zingers.
You do?
And he,
that's
I
your weakness?
Love zingers.
Watch this.
And he would bring me
this.
Zingers.
Nigga, I'd have came in the room with a zinger on the dick.
Oh, wow.
What you love? This dick zinger.
Zinger.
Oh, all right,
man. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Hi, Rollout.
Hi. My timing was off by 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Hey, Tantizi.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Tantizi.
Well, I'm going to get Mun some jeans for Christmas. He only wears like 2 pairs of jeans, so he's been complaining. So I'm going to get him some jeans.
Like how many pairs? Like one good one or a couple of pairs?
Can I help you, Tantizi? Can I help you?
What?
Okay.
I give him good gifts.
No. Let me finish.
Oh, here we go.
Okay, the jeans is cool. Mm-hmm. I mean, I would be like, oh, thank you. But you gotta add, like, if you're gonna
Speedy,
do
you're
jeans,
just spoiled.
Watch
your
girl, your
you
tone and delivery.
That's your problem. But go ahead.
Yeah, you stay focused. I'll put your ass in the closet. Look here. If you're gonna do jeans, you gotta get at least 3-4 pair.
Right.
Okay. Cool. And there's the place on Melrose. These Flyers. I forgot the name of them, but they like $75 a pop, $200 a pop. But
what?
Know.
Yeah. Melrose. I was thinking J.C. Penney.
Marshalls. How about Ross? Ross. All right. So jeans and what else? You can't just get jeans.
Just the jeans, time or what?
That's all he needs is some jeans.
Oh shit.
He's easy to shop for.
Yeah, you about to fuck up.
He said he's easy to shop for.
Yeah. I had a great joke, but I can't do that. Here's the thing. You got to add something to it. You got to have a throw-in.
Throw-in time with those.
Maybe a shirt here.
Roll-out shirt.
Hilarious. Yeah, roll-out shirt. No, you can't do a shirt, Tom. You got to do, you got to go get maybe the album that he don't, like the platinum album that he may not have in his room or so. You got to think outside the box.
No. She's like, no.
She said no.
That's a lot, God, Speedy.
Damn.
I wanted to say this about Kamara. Kamara, I love you on the show. You're a great addition to the show.
I hear a butt.
It's a butt. But I saw your stand-up, and I didn't really care for your stand-up. Because I think you started talking about kids or something in the beginning, and that just threw me off. I had to walk away.
All right. Thank you, Tom.
Thank you.
She never fails.
Disappoint.
No, that's how we ended up getting Kamara actually on the rollout. Is her stand up?
Yeah.
She came and I was like, Speedy, she's funny. Speedy was we're gonna.
Because she
on the
said
show.
Real shit. And
my opinion, you were hilarious.
Here's the thing about you gotta understand about Tom. She didn't like my joke about the.
Because she hates that joke.
Oh, because she has kids. But so that's why.
Yes.
And then so don't think it. But again,
if she don't like her stand up? Don't explain for her. She just says she don't like it. So it's okay. It's an opinion.
I still like Tom TV.
Okay, then fuck it.
All right,
bitch. We don't like you either. No.
But I was talking about my kids. Easy even make it better. I was talking about her. But I feel you though. I know.
But at the end of the day, she kind of like you.
No, that's good. I like her too. And I like that she wasn't scared to share her opinion.
Yeah,
well, she's
funny as hell on the show. Now you stand up, I can miss it. But the show.
She knows you. She didn't say it in that doorway. That shit on the phone. You can say, you can be real bold on the phone. Bitch, I don't like your mama or the shit you talk about with your mama. And hang up.
Right. Nah,
you get here and be like, hey, girl, you funny. How your daddy is. All right, so what you said you don't expect it much.
Okay.
What are you expecting, Pam?
So I don't like to be disappointed.
Like you won't sit
exactly. I'm with you, Tangie.
Pam? Yeah. Well, Pam?
Sorry, I can't. I'm not that. I'm very shallow. I'm expecting something. I don't care what, but I'm expecting something.
Like what? What do you want him
because
to
do?
Purse or something?
Ring.
Shoes.
Hair.
Ring. Dress.
Makeup.
No dress.
Say hair.
Pipe.
What if he got you a ring, Pam? Oh, wow.
Crazy. You better not. I bought his one for her birthday. She liked it. Remember I bought her one? We bought her one for her birthday.
Bought her one and what?
We bought her a little weed kit. Those are kind of weird gifts, though. If you give me a pipe, I'm going to feel like... Yeah. Even if we smoke together, I'm going to be like, so...
What if I gave you a pack of blunts? Would that be...
If my friends did, but if my nigga gave me a pack of blunts, I'm like, what you trying to say, nigga? This is all I am.
I'm give you a fly-ass lighter.
This
is a butane. I don't give a fuck.
Shoot, pay homage to the relationship, nigga, not my habits. Shit.
That's fucking
awesome. I wouldn't be mad at a
kit?
No, we're not.
No, I didn't say weed. I said a pipe.
Because that would save me money.
Christmas morning,
and then it's going to be gone.
So?
Christmas morning, you wake up, it's a box, and box is full of weed. Like bomb-ass weed.
That's bomb, but what's flyer is a purse full of weed.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like a fly purse and then put some weed in it. Nigga, that would be amazing. I was like, oh my God. And it was weed in it.
Oh, Gucci bag with Gucci shit in it.
I would have been so happy, bitch.
Every time you go to the airport, your bag, man, I know it came with some shit.
So, Pam, what?
I don't know what, but who said? I think you said, come here.
What if he bought you some 300s?
Sandals.
Well, there is those diamond ones that I saw. Those are really cute. But no, I don't know.
So don't get you shit that
not
you got.
Clothes, because I have abundance of those and nowhere to put them anyway. But I don't know what. But just think about the
relationship.
Jewelry. Yeah, jewelry be nice. Mm. And that's one thing. Don't get women clothes. Unless no, she's Tandy size.
Yeah. It's like we don't have the same style.
I don't want you shopping for my jeans and my shirts, okay? Just give me a gift card.
Because it's going to be embarrassing.
Yeah, I don't want you all like, she like this big, telling people, whatever, I buy my own clothes.
You walk in with a 9X. This good?
Yeah, I even got big feet. I don't want you going there like, she need an 11. I don't even want you saying that. Like,
are you just, 11?
Yeah, I'm 10-11. I'm 10-11.
You 10-11?
Yeah. That's a normal black girl foot, okay?
Oh, I thought you were my size, nigga. I was like, this not 10. No. I know what a 10 looks like. This ain't 10.
That's a lie for sure.
This ain't 10. This
I'm going to tell the fat girl 16, lie 18. That all fat girls tell I'm a 14. Every fat bitch is a 14. I am a 14.
Let me try it on. You be in there. Let me get a 14 and a 19. What'd you say, man? What'd you hear?
What'd you hear?
Every big girl you ask, you, I'm like 14, 16. No.
What size are you?
A 14, 16, nigga. Like, what do you mean?
Don't ask nobody that.
So don't buy clothes.
No shoes.
But he did ask me my shoe size, and I don't
well, unless it's tennis shoes, I guess. Men do buy tennis shoes, so I could see why he might have did that.
He did ask me that.
Well, he had a pair of one of those. Shoes. I mean, he gonna buy her a pair of one of those.
Don't buy me clothes. How about that?
Yeah.
But I think jewelry is too much.
Not
unless it's a
earrings.
Bracelet or
he
something.
He can get some earrings.
That's not thinking outside the box. For a dude, I don't think.
If they fly... He can give me some earrings.
Yeah. Earrings are a cool gift.
Boy, Tangy, in another life. Boy, I had you, nigga. I'd be right here going, nigga, I'd be like, these glasses, Tangy. When you wear these and look at me, you will see the world. Tangy be like, oh, shit. Shit. And I'd be like, you see that shit? Oh, you look big. Look how big I look, bitch.
I hate you.
You and this one, nigga, I'd have had you motherfuckers running. You'd have been like, Speedy said I can't do that.
I think Poe would have came up out of it.
Nigga.
Or if he did get Poe, it'd have been for a second. Like, the nigga said the earth and all that, but I don't know.
He said he's going to invest in this motherfucker. He ain't did it yet. Because I could have got it with that one. I'd have came in going,
oh, yeah.
What you need me to do?
I'm going to do all this. Now, that would have got her. Like, oh, you need all this right here? She'd have been like, I sure do. Yeah, that would have got her.
And she'd have started sucking and went, you ain't did shit.
Just sucking. I'll
do it while you sucking. If you suck with it, I will.
Hilarious. This show ain't shit. Perfume, gift cards to massages.
No perfume
for me.
I love perfume, and it's getting expensive the more you get into it. Like, you know, like,
but
what
if they give
it?
You
I
a fragrance? You don't
no perfume.
But that's what I try to tell them. Please get my fragrance. Like, don't just buy something you think will smell good on me because that might not work.
What is the purpose of buying something if I ask you what you want?
I'll give you this the shit I like. You got to give people what you like list. Just to help them out. We grown.
So I come in, I see a list. But what's this, grocery list? No,
yeah,
that's
just
what
like
I
need to know you don't like cheese on your burger. Like, why would I go buy? You know what I'm saying? Like, we grown. Like, I'm gonna give you a list of stuff that I like. You should already know though, because we fucking.
That's the thing about him being thoughtful. You should already know.
You should already know.
If I've never come over to your house smelling like perfume, don't buy me no perfume.
True.
And like you, I don't know you like that, but I know you like tennis shoes.
I know you like tennis shoes.
And I'm a player with my man. If I really like you, I'll boss you out. I'll take you to men's land and be like, pick whatever you want, nigga.
Men's land. Pick whatever you want.
Nigga, how old are the motherfuckers you date? They go to men's land.
If I took you to men's land, Ron, you'd be like, okay. He'd be turned right into the okay.
You better not do that, Ron. That nigga be taking selfies by all the suits. Now, that I like. Now, see, ladies, see, that's what I'm talking about. I don't know why you're single. I know why, because you're crazy as cat. But that's what I'm talking about. If you do that with your man, you go, hey, what'd you get me for Christmas? Come on with me. And you go in the store and say, go on, get what you want. Nigga,
that'll work.
Nigga be giddy. We be like, oh.
Yeah, yeah, but it still don't make y'all act right, though, because I did that.
That's how you know
a
motherfucker
right.
Really like it. When nigga hit you with the, all right. Like, damn, I got to rethink that gift. Goddamn. give me a minute. I'm going to do something with you. Because then that's when you got us.
Right.
If you get a gift and the dude go, okay, shoot. Case for my phone. All right. Thank you, baby. You negated the bullshit. Now, I went to the alley.
Oh, yeah.
So I went to go find a wallet for my bag, which is real. But I didn't know the motherfucker, so I'm trying to. And everybody like they don't know what the fuck I'm talking about.
Yeah,
I
want
to get a wallet for my bag. Well, no, we don't do that. No, we don't do that. What the fuck going on in the alley? So somebody grabs me before I go out the store. They go, you just look for somebody along the alley. They'll see you or you'll see them.
No, when you went into the store, they probably called that person. Well, they got the contact.
I come out of the store and my man peeled off the wall and said, what you looking for? I said, like me? Yeah. So, looking for a wallet for my bag? Oh, man, where you at? I said, across the street. Go stand by your car. Oh, okay.
I'm by my car. How I go now. It's
20 minutes late, nigga roll up on the bike. Psst. Yeah.
Oh. Really?
I thought nigga give me some cocaine. So nigga said, psst, follow me. So he riding the bike. I ride behind him with a little jog. Where nigga lead me to. Get to the corner. He said, here, go in. Just check it out. So nigga, my ass have it up. That nigga said, push it down. Oh, my bad. Looking around, I'm thinking, nigga, the police be here any minute. I'm looking at shit like.
You do. You,
I said,
you
oh, yeah. He showed me the fake one. Showed me the real one. The real. Allegedly. Real left. Well, whatever. Yeah. So I'm like, okay. But then I had to get my haggle on. I said, oh, shit. He said, how much you got? 40. Okay, I need you to drop the money on the ground. I'm going to step on it. You walk.
Really?
Nigga, you
exactly
walk.
How it is.
Nigga, I drop the money. He steps on it. I grab the shit and go.
Yeah. It's and a now, totally right? different world.
Can we go one day?
Hilarious. So you get everybody caught.
You want to experience that.
I promise I'll be quiet.
No, you're not, Tangie. No.
They're going to narc us out. They're going to be like, no, she didn't narc. She
but y'all don't want me to go by myself.
Tangie going to be looking like
by myself.
No, you don't want to go by yourself.
She went by herself. I was scared of shit. But
you were scared to go to the alley?
No. Look at that. She's all excited.
I know. That's what she's going to be looking like when we buying the wallet. They're going to be like,
who's this heaven high bitch? Why is she screaming heaven high?
I feel like she's gonna say, we got him. He's so excited.
What did you get?
I got a couple purses. I got a Chanel and a Louis Vuitton.
They spelled it with an S.
Well, okay, amen. And it's so funny. I walked away from the Chanel and then I was going to the ATM or something. He followed me on his bike like about 10 minutes my later. Was like, hey, man. You want that? You still want that Chanel? I was like, yeah. He was like, what you got? I said, like 30. He was like, okay.
So wait a minute. You went walk in the away. Store and
no,
you
it's
looked
at
it's
store.
Not a store. It's an alley.
You never been to the alley?
But it's not the alley.
It's the garment district.
Oh, I have been to the garment district.
You've been to Santee Alley, right?
Well, no, it's the alley. It's not the garment district.
Oh, we need to go there.
It's
my mama deserves a fake Chanel bag for $30. She deserves that. That got her name on it.
So this I go. So there's an alley, and they sell stuff in that alley.
Yep.
But they used to sell it in the booths.
Yeah,
but
the
customs
before.
Stopped them from doing that. Yeah. So now they have it somewhere else. They send a dude that walks around and he could tell what you looking for shit. And they go, dude look around like you're looking for some shit. They go like this. Psst. What you need? And you got the
yeah, you'd be shook. Like
because you're looking for the Louis bag.
But you're looking at clothes or something that's
yeah, you're looking at other purses, but you know, ain't.
But
like,
you don't see it, so you're looking at the purse.
And then you'll say, y'all don't have the real Louis? And they go, no, sir, no, sir. And then they make a call walking out the store.
They make a call, and then that person will find you. Like, yeah. She got on a camouflage jacket or whatever, and then he'll come up to you, and then they will say, follow me, but don't walk with me.
Yeah.
Follow a couple steps behind, and I followed him to somewhere else. I said, well, how far are we walking? I'm like, God damn. And then we ended up in another, like, weird-looking alley, and like on a dock type shit that was where I was. And then they had the shit in some garbage bags.
So wouldn't know it because customs and
you would never know.
And the police are there because they're trying to stop that. Mm-hmm. Well, really, it's the people, Louis people, who's trying to stop them from selling.
Yeah, they want you the fakes.
They have the fake now, the real. Mm-hmm. Allegedly.
Well, it probably is the real because they make it. Like,
but y'all not scared to follow somebody you don't know?
I did, but I mean, we were desperate. I went down there for that.
They know you there. They ain't gonna try it. I mean, don't get me wrong. Somebody might flip a script on you, but 9 out of 10, they want you to come back, tell your friends, oh yeah, just walk right here, they'll ride by and nobody.
I want to go.
I know. I think we should all go.
I think we should go. We not saying. We should
She's
go.
Like I'm taking tangent. I'm trying to buy my mama that Chanel for $30.
I promise I'll be good.
You'll be quiet. We need you to be quiet is what we need you to do.
Give me my character and I'll be in character.
Yeah, we don't need you to be having high.
I'll even dress different from myself. Yeah. I promise.
Don't smile. We don't need you to be bright.
There you go.
We need you to be down with the people.
Yeah, I need you to be right in here. And when they ask you a question, just go.
Yeah. See, look.
Right then, I'll be like, "Nah, we don't have nothing. No, we ain't got shit, bitch."
I wanna go.
Even when Tenji not smiling, she look like a smile trying to burst out.
It is the Rollout Show right here, Morris Media. We take a quick break. Come right back. It is Weird Wednesday. A lot of shit going on Wednesday. We got some news. We got weird news or some kind of news that is weird. On the equipment back there is our girl Sky.
Killing it.
Go.
Sky.
Go
ahead.
Go,
Ron. Where Brooklyn at? Where Brooklyn at?
Where Brooklyn at? Go on and on and on and go take them to the crib unless they boning. Easy. Call them on Ron, you are goddamn nigga. That Biggie mix. Shit. I'm gonna need that pimp.
Yeah, Ron, you've been killing the other day. I said, if I ever have a party.
Good.
Look, if I ever have a party.
Yeah, if you're a party of your job.
She could do my soul.
I'm coming.
Party. They hire some wagon.
Ron, we gotta hire you, dog. Anyway. It is the Rollout Show right here. Just voice be Doggy Dog, the funniest motherfucker you ever gonna meet, besides Kamir's dad. But you'll never meet him, so there it is. It is now time for. Apparently, there's an echo in this motherfucker. Somebody got it on their
phone. It's Ra.
Turn your shit down, Rocky.
Speedy's affirmation of the day.
Come and talk to Speedy. He really wants to meet you, girl. He has an affirmation for you. There you go, ladies. Come on, everybody say,
oh, come and talk to Speedy. He has an affirmation for you.
I want to brighten up your day. Yes, ladies. I like how you said that. I'm eating. You, bitch.
Oh. Oh. Ew.
Now, this is just a little shit from my brain that I'm throwing at you. Fellas, if you can't convince them, confuse them.
Oh. Wow. Really,
you can't make the bitch do what you want to do. Confuse that bitch.
That's pervertish.
That type of shit work on me. That's why I hate when men drive me crazy. Like, no, it's you. I'll be like, what'd I do? I don't like that.
You
don't
ain't working the dick right, bitch.
Okay.
No, it ain't an affirmation. Ain't nothing to add to it. We moving on.
Can I rebut?
No. No.
What a rebut?
No.
Why can't she rebut?
No. Right. I said for the fellas, if you can't convince them, confuse them. Now,
actually, that's kind moving of true. On.
I just wanted an example.
No.
I love it.
I hate her. Can you explain? No, bitch, I can't. I said you can't come over. Well, why can't I come where your friends are? Because I said you can't come. Hey, the motherfucker. Well, I just want to come. See, I don't want you to come by. I'm finna fuck another bitch. You can't come over.
What?
That's why I want you to come over here, because we're fucking bitches. And Tangie hit you with it. I just want to see what you guys do. I want to hang out with. No, bitch! We play
Tangie
ball.
Seems like she'll make you feel bad. I think that's the only bitch that'll convince you not to fuck the other bitch. Like,
yeah, because you're like, well.
Well, if that's what your spirit is telling you to do.
That's where heaven high is.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
Look, and she'll be the motherfucker. Here, take some condoms.
Yeah,
you gave me Magnum too, bitch? I ain't gonna like fucking this bitch. I'm just gonna do it. Keep pushing me. Tangie. America. Fellas. I'm telling you, if you need the blueprint, me and Ron can give you the blueprint for this one. You a thug nigga. I can give you the blueprint on this one. You ain't got to buy no whole, you buy a blue rag, nigga, and just say, I'm gonna put this in your back pocket. Really?
He's stupid.
I like this nigga.
Can't put the blue rag in my back pocket.
I'm gonna show you how to tuck this in, baby. Just had a little piece hang out the back. Yeah, bitch, we roll together. You too easy. And poet is easy. Pam.
Poet is complicated.
Nigga, Pam, you
yeah,
a.
I think poet,
Pam, the kind of motherfucker you buy a car for, she'd be like, that's not the color. Bitch, I bought you a car. Put a ribbon on it. She'd be like, I don't like Volkswagens.
True.
Bitch, he gonna run you over in that motherfucker.
Wow, really? Damn.
Run. I mean, not Run. Rock is here. Y'all know Rock.
Rock. The dog dick dirty motherfucker.
I have to know the story because I have to know about this dog dick he got. Yeah. Like,
you gotta go over there and grab it. Yeah, nigga. You grab shit.
You
got
Speedy tell us, dick.
Speedy tell him how he got
it. It's a couple of stories, but this, I think that one was
Palm Springs.
That was Palm Springs the year before.
No, that was the year before. I'm talking about this year.
This year he bought.
Now, I like big bitches. Okay. As you know. Uh-huh. This bitch 6'2 and some change. But she was in the paint kind of bitch. Like, she post you up. She came over. Now, she was at the thing. Every nigga there was trying to. I said, who the big young bitch? God damn.
Big young.
Look the other way. Look the other way. And dog dick bought her home.
He did.
Oh. But here was the problem. She had nowhere to sleep. So
this motherfucker, let me jump in.
He pushed all them out their bed.
But yeah, first of all, my blow up bed. Well, my ex's boyfriend. Well, anyway, my blow up bed.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, finally. I think somebody had left. Whoever had left the house early, but I was like, I could sleep on my bed tonight. He's like, I already put my stuff on it. I'm like,
yeah, you have to mark your territory.
You put your stuff on my bed. All right. So let the nigga have the bed. Fuck it.
Nigga, 6'2 and some change came in.
Yep. This nigga fucking this bitch on my blow up bed.
Now, we coming in that morning.
You should have known that wasn't going to work.
We coming in that morning. I thought we were in the gym. I said, ooh.
Oh.
So, Poe said.
True that.
Poe said, because she already mad because niggas.
Poe's in the living room.
Poe in the living room on the couch, hot as fish grease. So ain't nobody tell this bitch take a shower? And the girl standing
can't
right there.
I go nowhere without it.
The girl standing right there. The girl went. And Pete, they didn't even look at the bitch. You, bitch, you. You big bitch.
Yeah, kind of lost it.
And so B said, so I slept on the couch so we can do this shit here. And she mad at me.
True that. She didn't say that.
I'm like, why are you mad? Because of this shit here. And so anyway, so this is shit you missed. Nigga, we didn't know we had to tiptoe around Poe. Nigga, I'm in the living room going to the kitchen. Nigga, Poe said, how many times you niggas gonna get some meat? Nigga, I'm trying to walk in the dark. Nigga, I'm cooking with the light from the microwave open. Because I'm too scared to turn on the light. Because all the lights will come on. So, nigga, I'm trying to read the cookbook in the microwave. I'm like, nigga, what? And 2 cups of water. And then Poe ain't sleep the whole time. She's like, this is the bullshit. I was like, oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were asleep. Nigga, Poe, and this nigga bought that bitch. It was funky.
No, what happened was.
Was the room
Kamara.
Funky? Was the room funky?
Oh, my God.
They come in 2-3 o'clock in the morning. I'm supposed to have
in.
A room.
Speedy
period.
And the three white girls. Okay,
before
go
we got there, the plan was I have my own room because Canoe was coming down.
Oh.
And well, but the first two nights I had to give up the room. I think Pam had.
I got
the room.
It. Me and Vanessa.
Yeah, Pam and Vanessa shared the room. So I'm in the living room on the couch. They come in like 2-3 o'clock. It's Michelle and all her
white girlfriends.
Watch your tongue.
Okay, your tongue. I don't have to say it. Pam could finish the story. And then they in there in the kitchen clacking pans.
Because we in the dark.
No lights on, clacking pans. Okay, first time I didn't say nothing. Second time I didn't say nothing. Third
but
time.
Was breathing. You was breathing. She was like.
Third time I was like, how many times y'all niggas gonna go back and forth to the kitchen?
So Michelle's friend said, I think that girl in the living room is upset. I said, y'all woke her up. I told you, motherfuckers, go around the other way. I had told you because it was another way to get to the kitchen.
Out the back,
you go out the
back
go out
door,
the fucking back door back, and come in through
door.
The thing. They was walking past anyway.
Oh, yeah.
It was bad.
Now that was funny.
Yeah, we were real bad.
But I don't know. My and Speedy was like, don't trip. She lives alone.
You know what, motherfucker, live alone.
She
you can't be walking around.
Yeah.
Nigga, you spend the night and somebody live alone. Don't you get up in the middle of the night like, hey, you got. Motherfucker, like, what? I just. Can I use the bathroom? In the bathroom in their room.
We have a call.
Oh,
that's the worst shit. When the bathroom in their room?
Yeah.
Nigga, you like.
I cannot. That nigga said he was cooking with the microwave light on.
Yeah, I was not trying to wake up Poe.
Let's take this call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
I'm Chris from Connecticut.
Hey, Chris. Hey, Chris from Connecticut.
Chris, if you coming with the jokes, one.
I see what I can do.
Right. I see what I can
do. The women are looking nice today, especially Kamara. But,
thank you, because I thank you.
it's a throw-on outfit.
The Farrakhan finger waves aren't going to make it.
How you going to bring me up to kick the chair underneath me? What kind of shit? Nigga had me high. Drop me on the floor.
The Farrakhan
took me riding on a rocket and gave me a stop.
I just want to comment on what Poetess was talking about earlier about the gifts. Mm. And honestly, I'm not joking, but I think like Canoe would look at you different if you just got him a beanie.
Thank
with
you.
A light on
with a fucking light. That ain't gonna work. I try to tell him, thank you, brother.
Thank you.
Y'all got to understand. Nigga, I'll be hot.
Beanie.
Yeah.
Beanie, I have the floor now.
Oh.
I need an off button. Okay.
But, yeah, it's like what Speedy was saying earlier. You know, dudes, you know, we're grateful, but we don't, besides electronics, we're not into
practical gifts.
Yes, and 6 months is a dude's. If a dude is sticking around for 6 months, consciously, he loves you. And,
great call, man.
Consciously. Or unconsciously.
You can do better than a...
Well, what do you suggest, Chris?
Yeah, what do you think, Chris?
Well, guys, you know, besides electronics, again, you don't want to spend money. I mean, at least go out your way erotically and, you know, do something electro, you know, and candles, incense, just, you know, just something to throw him off to be like, man.
Suck his dick while he ain't looking.
Yeah, exactly. With a grape, right?
Yeah, catch me off guard. What you doing, bitch? Oh, in church? Okay, we ain't gonna stop here. Bible
in
study.
Church.
Mistletoe near the dick or whatever.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's some player shit.
It is.
I'm laying on his lap, you be like, beam.
Nigga be carrying a mistletoe all year. He like, I got that thing, bitch. I know it's shriveled up. But
it before I go, I just want to, I know Pam's going through stuff in her relationship, and she just had some free time. One of these days, me and her could try the letter T, if you know what I mean.
The letter T, Pam.
I'm scared even to ask.
What is it, Chris? What's the letter T?
He's listening. Oh, Lord. What?
What's the letter T?
What's the letter T, Chris?
That nigga hung up. Hung greatest up? Call in the world.
have you dreaming about him?
You can't convince him. Confuse him. See? Okay. See? High word tangent?
Oh, he called to give... Thank you, Chris, for giving us the example.
Yeah.
Now, how are we supposed to feel now that we're confused? Are we supposed to be
you was just standing there like, you ain't going nowhere.
But is that
going
to make us want to answer his call when he calls the next time?
It has to be resolved. And as long as she's going, what's the T? And so when he calls back again, what's the T mean? She's still standing there going, what's the T? Because y'all need to have.
Oh, because I'm confused.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to confuse all you.
All right, now it's time.
It is now time for. Well, maybe it's not time for. According to.
Oh, here we go. Ron is enjoying the show.
It is now time for The Poetess Report, starring The Poetess.
This just in.
Your mouth, biatch. Mistletoe in your mouth. Put it in your mouth. Yeah, suck dick on call. But if you can't buy a great gift, you should just, for 1 week, suck dick.
Every day?
As soon as I walk in the door.
How long?
Y'all niggas love that shit. That's what
she said. Would it be relaxing dick sucking or to make you come?
Well, you couldn't buy me no gifts because you broke. Mm. Make your mouth work.
Yeah, but is it to make you come or just to make you feel good? Like you want to just play with it for an hour?
I'm gonna come.
An hour?
Well, you
quiet. Go to the Poetess Report. What the hell?
Why are you looking at the clock? This is why are you looking at the clock? Let it happen for an hour.
1 hour?
Yeah, that's
you'll get locked. 1 hour?
Yeah, that's too long to suck some dick. Sorry.
Hey. There's no
sex. There's nothing on earth you suck for 1 hour.
Do you eat coochie for an hour?
Yes. Yeah. Thank you, Rob.
When you eat coochie, can I defend coochie eating? You are in a relaxed position, okay?
Right.
It's only a you know how hard it is to do for an hour?
But that's
an hour.
Hold on. Can you do it? You get a little snore when you do it. Don't just jerk your head. I need you to enjoy it. See, that's the problem. Y'all have to act like you enjoy. Don't be like, what is this up here? Don't look at my dick and go, I guess I'll
do. We do examine the dick.
Don't do that.
Yeah, we are.
That fuck up the moment. Then I'll be like, get my shit back.
Tangie was just playing America. That was a...
No, yes, pay for sucking.
Hold on.
Y'all be quiet, Tangie, so we can go ahead with the Porter's report. No more hour dick sucking talk.
I actually enjoy that a lot.
An hour?
But...
Why are you single?
That's why I asked the objection.
She just
because
say, you enjoy dick sucking?
Because
Tangie, listen, play the music, right?
But
then...
But there is, like, if I'm a suck it because I just want to love that part of your body, then it's wonderful. We can watch TV while I do it.
Oh, wow.
But,
oh,
God damn.
But.
Wait, let me tell you this. Stop.
But
shut
listen.
Up. Wait, let me, hold on. Every dude in America at the cubicle is going, oh, who's this? I gotta call in. What's the number to call in? 323-293-3375.
But that's different if it's that kind of guy that just wants to come. Like even if somebody's going down on me, it's not the end result. It's all that in between. So if he's just gonna make me feel good, yeah, he can be down there loving me.
You mean doing commercials?
He's just trying to make me come. He's a dirt commercial. You know, then
I'm just saying, doing a commercial, you gonna be sucking?
Yeah.
Rock, you
anyway, can I live
through
the news.
Hold on, can I live through somebody in this moment? Ron, can you take over the team?
I don't know what dog dick just jumped up. I don't know.
we'll get to that one. Go ahead. What you got? Damn, Tangie.
Anyway.
Doing the commercials?
Forbes just released their top YouTube earners.
Oh,
this motherfucker's on YouTube earning big money.
Just regular people?
Regular people, non-celebrities. This is their second annual ranking of top paid YouTube stars. Mm-hmm. There's 12 in the top 10 that earned a combined $70.5 million in the past 12 months.
12 months?
Over the past year. Wow. The top goes to PewDiePie. I guess he's that? Like a gamer, a YouTube gamer. Okay. He goes on there and he, I guess, plays video games while people
on
watch
YouTube?
Or something.
My
like
son
that
probably
shit.
Watches him. He watches all those.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I think
he
I
earned $15 million.
Damn.
On YouTube views.
Just from the views?
Yes.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yep, and he's the first person ever to reach 10 billion YouTube views.
Okay, that's just, people are watching him play the game.
I think that's who he is. I never really,
yeah, you watch him play
heard.
The game.
Rock, is that what it is?
And they'll talk about the game and they'll explain how to play and, you know, show different
kids
ways
doing
that,
Googling
that.
Yeah, knowing all the tricks and stuff like that. Like, remember Mario had little tricks and, you know, we got to tell you back then. But yeah.
So, Rock, you know who this guy is?
I know of him. Like, when I was hanging out with the game.
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay.
So people challenge him around the world and play games with them.
But he does it on YouTube to get...
Right.
Wow, that's dope.
Wow.
Shit. Who's next?
Roman Atwood, he does pranks. And he made $8 million.
Rock probably watches that too. I see them jump off bridges and all that stuff all the time.
He does pranks. Wow. And then Lily Singh, she is
a... That's a makeup girl, huh?
She's the she does impersonations of her parents. She's like an Indian girl.
Oh, okay.
And she made $7.5 million.
Okay, when you say Indian, you mean the country.
The country, India. Yeah.
India.
And I say Native American if they're from here. Smosh, they made $7 million. They're a sketch comedy duo.
Wow. Really?
Smosh. Why does that sound familiar?
I never heard of
that. Probably because they're making $7 million on YouTube.
I know the dudes that did the basketball. Now they had a TV show, but they were doing the tricks with the basketballs.
Yeah.
Got
and then the girl I mentioned, she got a makeup. And she just started out doing tutorials on how to do makeup. Now she got a makeup line, a makeup empire.
Yeah. Right. And
like,
they say
it's
that
crazy.
That these people not only are monetizing on YouTube, but they're selling books and merchandise and...
Damn, $8 million.
A Vine star ended up on Dancing with the Stars. I'm like, really?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
So it's just you got to come up with something.
Does everybody monetize their YouTube account?
If you're trying
to be smart enough to do it,
smart, you do it.
Yeah, if you have the content and people are watching and you're not posting copywritten stuff. Mm. Yeah, and so
anybody black?
Not in the top five, no.
Mm. Okay, that means we in the top 10, though.
But people are making livings off of the guy that's making the $15 million. He was going to school, I think, to be some kind of engineer or had an engineering job, and he quit his job. His parents, they said, were pissed, and
now they
he
need
got
help.
A job at a hot right. dog stand to sustain, you know, to make mm-hmm. money mm-hmm. and build his YouTube shit.
Well, you wow. know, we all about the hashtag.
Now he's making, last year he made $12 million. This year he made $15 million.
Wow.
I mean, Instagram, say, people are monetizing their Instagram and living off of Instagram.
Yeah, the really? Kardashians.
Yeah, they're making millions.
How you make money off of Instagram? You can tell I ain't making
advertising
money.
Advertising their stuff. Yeah. Getting sponsors really? To mm-hmm. post yeah. pictures.
Well, I just know my... Well, I have two comments. First, I think that's what Russell was doing, because I keep telling everybody, I'm like, Russell hires us to make his channel funny.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He must be getting a gang of money from this free YouTube channel that we can all do ourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we can all make our
Russell,
own content.
Though. You can and you should.
Yeah, like that's what I was saying. In our own channel and make our own channel funny like we making his channel funny.
I thought you were about to say dude was your cousin. I thought that's probably
we'll go there later.
Who's your cousin?
We'll talk about it.
Okay. Like, next story, you guys.
The second story. I was going to say about the Instagram. Once you book, my friend has about 70,000 followers. Mm-hmm. People send her hair, all kind of stuff. If you wear the hair and say, shout out to the hair, we'll give you money. We'll keep sponsoring you here. We'll keep giving you. So if you wear this sweater, they send her all kind of stuff just because she got the followers.
Yep, that's true.
Shit.
So.
Yeah, they do. There's, I saw also a couple that had these two kids that come in and critique toys.
What?
Mm-hmm. And they make millions of dollars a year, and all
they like the toy or not.
Yep, and all the toy companies
start sending
free toys.
Just mention it.
I've seen that with the hair, with the natural hair. They send them all these natural wigs, and they talk about whether the wig is good or not, and they get paid for that. Mm-hmm. So I have seen that.
Yeah, I do the
makeup
tutorials.
So what you trying to say? We ain't thinking outside the box. We need to.
No, we do it. It's just not. It's about hashtags. It's about. It's the job. That is a full time job in a way. It's not something you just throw up there and the people are going to find. It is. It's a strategic marketing campaign to do that. You have
like when get your followers up.
You have to target certain audiences.
Pam tag our show and stuff, and she do it all the time.
Yeah, I'm always tagging everything. I have like 15.
Throw me under the bus, dude. Ease me under a bus. What the fuck is wrong with you?
That's
you see my symbol. That's me, dude. You see me. Don't just throw me. Don't hurt.
Anyway.
Here's another good story. A store sells a lottery ticket with wrong numbers. So this guy goes in. He gives the store guy the numbers to put in a little machine to get his lottery ticket. The machine printed out the wrong numbers, but the wrong numbers happened to be the winning numbers.
Oh.
And the couple won $1 million.
That was God.
Yeah,
I don't know.
they was meant to get that, for real.
Yeah.
Now, what if he would have put in, got his right numbers, and it was the other way around, and they gave him the wrong numbers, and he had the winning numbers.
Oh. They wouldn't have been able to prove it, I don't think. They wouldn't have let him get
Nobody
it.
Nobody would have known, right?
Just like that casino woman, remember?
Yeah, true that. I wouldn't have said shit. Oh, well, thank you.
He won shit.
Yeah, well, that was a won't he do
it
moment.
Paid for it.
What city was that?
That was in New Jersey somewhere.
Damn.
Lakewood, New Jersey.
Maybe that was the mob.
The weird shit is like whenever the store that has the winning tickets, everybody go there like, niggas, it's not going to happen again.
Right.
You ever won in the ticket?
No.
Bam.
Because my family has.
I said you, nigga.
No, not me, but my family got in Louisiana $300,000. And after Katrina, too. Right after.
Well, that was good.
That was good. Won't he do it again?
Okay, next story. I'm kind of rushing through this because we do have a guest in the house that's on a schedule. So, police officer accused of slapping a man in a bunny costume. And what's crazy about this story is that the police officer actually got charged.
For hitting the bunny?
For hitting the bunny?
For hitting the man with the bunny costume. The guy in the bunny costume comes into the police station to turn himself in. But he comes in with one of those loud-ass air horns.
Yeah. Oh. Oh, yeah.
And so the cop was like, stop doing it. And he kept blowing the air horn, and the cop punched him in the face. It was caught on video.
He was white.
Yeah, I said, but it was a white bunny.
Black folks do less than that. And they, you know, right. No love. I mean, cops do more than that.
Yeah.
We went in and said, it's a man with a bunny costume.
You would have got shot for pointing out the bunny dude. Hey, the bunny got, nigga, why am I going to jail? I said, the bunny outside.
Man arrested for breaking into an apartment to steal the Wi-Fi code.
Oh, God.
I'm mad.
Hey, sometimes you got to get
stingy
line,
with the
man.
Wi-Fi code. Give it up.
Don't you feel guilty because somebody else go, do you got Wi-Fi? Okay, what's your code? Then they say some weird 675-5454. Yeah. Then you go. Then you have to go, what was it again? 655-5555-54.
Why do you got Wi-Fi if you don't want to share it? Like,
they act so stingy with that shit, though.
Damn.
They might only pay for a certain amount or something, and then it will slow their stuff down if you using it and you using
well,
it.
Okay,
you
but still.
It.
You ain't good company. Why are you on your shit while we all at your house? You're right. Supposed to be entertaining tonight.
Now, I would go over my Aunt Betty, rest in peace. She's in her 80s, and she had internet, and she would not give me her Wi-Fi code because she thought I would get into her computer. And I'm like, well, Aunt Betty, what are you doing on the computer that you don't want anybody to see?
Because
you come over her house,
uh-huh.
There's a big sign on her screen that says, do not touch
wow,
my computer. And she wouldn't even let us use the Wi-Fi or anything. But police arrested this guy. He first went down there and asked the lady for her Wi-Fi code, and she said no.
Mm.
So he broke into her house.
Bitch.
To get the Wi-Fi code, and he was arrested on third-degree burglary.
Yeah, you're going to jail.
Third degree for the Wi-Fi?
And that's third degree is pretty bad.
Damn.
Wow.
Like, that should have been like petty theft. The Wi-Fi code?
No,
like,
they'll knock it down, but they had to hit you with the high one. So when they go, oh, we're going to give you 6 months, you go, okay, cool. Because they wouldn't give you the third-degree shit.
Right.
Not okay, last story, and then we're going to bring our guest in. Things women could not do in 1960 or prior.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I knew that.
I know some.
Shit about to happen. Rehab.
Vote.
Vote. You almost right, Speedy. Legally use contraception.
I was saying.
In every state.
About to change
Only
that.
In 1965 did the Supreme Court make it legal for states to ban married people from using protection.
Wow.
When is those kids? Make money on the kids. Go ahead.
You couldn't refuse to have sex with your husband.
Bitch, give it here. Give it here or go to
jail. Until the 70s.
I wonder if anybody went to jail for that.
Mm-hmm.
It's some petty nigga that put his wife in jail. You know he did.
Hot damn, I told Betty, shoot, give me some pussy. I don't give a fuck, she my sister. I told the bitch, give me some pussy.
Oh, wow. Bad joke. Until the 70s, marital rape was illegal.
Yeah.
Wow.
Rape was defined in all U.S. states as follows. A male who has sexual intercourse with a female, not his wife, is guilty of rape.
Or black.
Wow.
Damn.
Wow.
Come on.
You couldn't live with your boyfriend.
Pam, going to jail. Pam, you going to jail, bitch. You are locked up.
Look, don't even, why me?
You and Sean and all your little shit. The fucked up shoes you wear, all that shit, you all going to jail.
Oh, shit, baby.
Okay, you guys, we're going to take a quick break and get our guests set up, and we'll be back in a minute.
Real quick.
That's the report.
You are.
Yo, I ain't been out a second. And already got to do some motherfucking chin and checking.
Whoa,
that. All right. It is the Rollout Show right here at Morris Media. It's your boy, Sweet Doggy Dog, in the building. The funniest motherfucker you ever gonna meet.
Damn.
Yeah, that's
it.
Crazy.
Is. Trust me, it's the funniest motherfucker you ever gonna meet. Yeah. Are you gonna be that Mercury?
I didn't disagree. They did. I said damn.
Okay, cool.
What does damn mean?
Like, damn, y'all, they disagreeing with your ass.
Your last motherfucking Wednesday. You know. You and your... Oh, you got an Uber here?
you taking me home, nigga.
We ain't gonna put it off on TEEFLII.
There's a whole lot of options here.
Nobody else in here is taking me home. Y'all all got something to do. You taking me home.
Ron.
Ron, like, you already know the bitch can't get in my car. You see this face? You see this face? You see
that nigga got speakers over there with a seat go.
Nigga, what?
Sitting at Sir in Vegas. Speaker, Ron.
I'm like, no, no, don't put me in it. Don't put me in it.
Come on, Ronnie. Rock, what you doing later?
I got a lot of shit to do.
Look, see? I got no. You gonna put me look, in the car look, with no, dog like dick? You don't even love me.
All right, you gotta do like that. Ask me, can I give you, ask me for a ride home.
Speedy, you gonna give me a ride home?
I mean, if you going that way, my mama called and shit. You but Pam, you
what?
You don't need to go where you at.
Oh shit, I drove, huh?
You drove?
God damn it.
Ah, Pam gonna get a ride.
Nah, I'm finna go sit in your front seat right now.
Forgot I drove. Okay.
It is the Roll Out Show. I'm gonna do my let's come after this because we got special guests in the building.
TEEFLII
yep. In the building.
What it do, what it do, what it do.
What it do. All right.
I'm a fan of TEEFLII. I remember the first time on the Reach Around Radio when DJ always played Get This Dick, and I was like, what kind of shit is this?
Turn it up.
Is this what these young niggas is talking about? Yeah, then I start loving that song.
Yeah, you think? Yeah. It's for motherfuckers like you that don't get the dick. Apparently you wasn't.
Throw her under the bus like that.
Yeah, women in dick. Hashtag canoe. You feel me? Like, what canoe? Leave her alone.
Did you say hashtag?
This is my type of conversation. Welcome to me.
Hey.
TEEFLII is, I would say maybe the... Do you feel some kind of way when people say the new Nate Dogg? Because you do sing on a lot of people's stuff, but you also stand alone on your own thing. So how do you feel about that?
I don't care. I just make good music. Try to make the best music. You know, turn up.
The check clear. That's all.
Yeah, that's all.
Yeah, just as long as that happens, you know. And publishing is cool. You know, I'm straight. I don't really
care.
Lucky
I can't sing. I'll be on every nigga out. Yeah, I'll do it.
That's why you ain't.
Yeah, do it.
That's all you
hear. That would be your hook. For
yeah,
real?
Do it.
I hope not.
Right on. Put the dick in your mouth.
Oh, wow.
Put the dick in your mouth. TEEFLII, I'm ready. You want to get me the studio.
You wasn't supposed to use my name after you said that.
Oh, okay. not after
that case.
All right. Let me do it right there. Charles, is it cool? Gummy name. Look at Charles.
Start making up names.
Now, you was in Palm Springs, what, 2 years ago?
Yeah.
And destroyed that motherfucker. Because I remember we were there, P. We were outside at that. We were really outside then.
Yeah.
With the other girl. Anyway. and the song blew up. It was number one, right? Number one song?
Number five. It went to number five. Top five song in the country.
Did you see that coming or what? Did it catch you off guard? Or were you in the studio going, this shit hot?
Man, I was like, you know, I still be stuck, you know?
Damn.
It ain't like, you know, a dude from L.A., you know, really just show up on the mart like that. So I was happy, you know?
I know everybody in your family called.
My kids was happy.
Kids? We can go to Toys R Us, Daddy!
How many kids you got?
They was the happiest. I got four.
Four, okay.
Yeah.
Big,
half
little.
As many as people.
Oh, I got twins. You know, I got twins. Oh, a boy nice. And a girl. Mm. And you know, I got
And you
two.
Got the ghetto twins? They just happen to be the same age?
Actually, they came out at the same time.
Same vagina. Yeah.
Damn, Pam.
What is the show turning into?
I don't think whoever's going to come after that is going to be too happy.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's, oh, wow.
Them is two people.
You got to prove
two,
that one, then.
Them is two people.
Yeah.
So you have a new album coming out, Annie, Are You Ote 5.
Yes, ma'am.
Drops this Friday. Now, what's the whole thing behind this whole Annie? Are you okay? Because you say that in
somehow,
like a lot
some
of
way,
all your
you know,
records.
I just got a, you know, I got kind of hip to her. You know, she's dope. You know, she turns up. She's it.
Oh, okay, that's what that means in your mind.
Metaphor?
Yes, a metaphor.
She's the shit.
Okay.
All right.
So I think it's this one. Man. I think it's committed.
I want to know, what's your type of woman? Like, you going out to the club or whatever, and you see a chick, what do you look for?
Not at the club.
Okay. Well, okay. Oh, then nice. Where do you go? Okay.
Bible study.
I mean,
I doubt that.
Look at that bitch with
man,
the
pimple. I'm trying to tell you, at church, you'll find some amazing things.
Biggest freaks, right?
Yeah. Pam. Well, I don't know. How you know?
Yeah, Pam. What the fuck?
How you know?
Because she a freak.
She a freakily.
She go to first A&M.
And I go study the word.
I suck your dick after offering.
Oh, wow.
Too soon?
Too soon.
That was kind of...
We ain't shit.
Yeah. That was dope. That was dope.
See, he likes stuff like that. After the offering? Okay, see, I got me a cool one.
That's a cool one. Trying to hurry up and get my money in the plate.
Yeah. Here, bitch, go. Hurry up.
Oh, this bitch finna suck dick. Hold on,
NFL
man.
Sunday is on.
So, TEEFLII, who are some of the singers that you look up to?
R. Kelly, Jodeci, young Jodeci though. Mm.
Oh, okay.
young R. Kelly
not,
too.
Not pre,
no, I like pre-pick. R. Kelly that was pissing on people too.
Ah, oh, damn.
To each his own, man.
Hey, piss you on know? The bitch, make
I
a hit.
Only support pre-pissing.
Everybody,
R. Kelly, but
everybody forgot about him pissing on somebody. Yeah. You know, so shit. Let him do his thing.
Okay, yeah, so Jodeci, R. Kelly.
Big fan of like oldies. You know, like I was born and raised in. You know, up on like oldies, Luther Vandross, you know, Marvin Gaye, you know, all okay. these dope ones, you know. My favorite is Anita Baker.
Oh, okay.
That's cool. That's,
oh,
wow,
that's
yeah.
my baby.
Now, do you have a lot of collaborations on this new album or?
Actually, that's crazy you ask because the first side is two sides to the CD. Mm-hmm. So,
two-sided CD.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd try to flip that over. Hold on.
You can flip it over?
We're talking about two different CDs.
Oh, double CDs. Yeah, I was about to say, that's what they're doing now.
Because P would have been like,
she said, what? All I got to do is flip it over?
It ain't playing. This nigga lied to me. It ain't no lines on this side. Because we got to look for them lines. This nigga, put a needle on it.
Nah, but it's actually, you're going to like this one. You get 37 songs.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
people don't do that no more.
How long did it take you to do that?
Actually, like a couple of months. You know, for a minute though, I stopped. You know, I had to take a break because I was fighting for custody for my twins. So I actually won. So,
there you go, man. You got money.
You know, that's dope.
You can win every time. You work at Taco Bell, you take a L. Bitch, I'm in the drive thru. You gonna drop the kids off now? What's that bullshit? You want hot sauce? You want cold sauce?
Hi, Daddy.
I gave her a taco. Nah,
they be
actually,
calling you your twins in the lobby, you know, niggas.
Actually, I got to win and you know, actually get to see these two beautiful kids grow up. And, you know, after that, it took a lot of stress off. And, you know, it's like time to get back to work. So, practically like in a 4-month span.
Now, was there somebody you wanted to collab with that you couldn't, or the schedules didn't fit?
No, I'm very cocky, and I feel like it's too many jockers out there. So, if you want to work with me, you'll work with me.
No.
Oh, okay.
Poetess.
Hey,
get your ass in the studio.
But I'm a workable person. You feel me? Like I love working. You feel me? Like being in the lab, coming up, you know, creative, you know. Coming up with those hits that everybody like to hear, you know, that's more so where I'm at, you know, but I don't really like feed into calling people and being a hype up dude. Like, man, can I get a song with you? You feel me? I was on everybody's song when I first came out.
Yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So it's nothing different. It's just a new, you know, new sound.
Now you're on the style. Show. Is there something about you that people don't know that you can tell?
What? I'm tell ratchet. Them.
Are you a ratchet?
Yeah.
See,
maybe you're a good father. I mean, you just want custody.
They're gonna see that regardless.
Yeah, they're gonna see that. But being ratchet and with money, that so what do you mean? Like,
I don't think you're ratchet. That's my
like you carry your own ketchup when you go to McDonald's, bitch. I got it.
You
said,
hot sauce.
You said you don't think I'm ratchet.
No, I don't see that from you at all.
Have you heard his music?
I heard the music, but I mean, sitting here talking to him, he's talking about his kids, and you know,
yeah, because you know, at the end of the day, you know, we doing an interview. I feel like it's a time and a place for everything, you know. But that don't mean that
You must not have seen the show before.
We ratchet.
Yeah, well, I'm like,
this side of the room.
I can kind of tell you know, he.
Right in here.
With them two over there. Yeah, you feel
you.
Me?
Thank you.
You ain't really showed me too much. Yet, you feel
cause
me?
She boozy.
I'm watching you. My eye is on you. I got you now. Since you.
Anybody got any crack? We'll find out right now.
Put a little sugar
got
in
that
it.
Book of sugar.
She'll test it, be like, uh-uh, that ain't real.
That ain't real. Uh-uh, because in 1998, they didn't have it like this. Uh-huh. It used to come like this.
It's too big. This can't be. Okay.
So, TEEFLII, you said that mainly you would prefer people come to you, but is there a singer or an artist if you had the choice to work with?
Of course. It's always those artists that you dream. You know, those
and
are
who
dreams.
Would that be?
Damn, that's a good question. Like, I would see. That's like something you should ask me. Like, if an artist was like dead or alive, like
dead or
Michael,
alive,
okay. Michael Jackson. You feel me? Like,
okay.
You know, somebody like that. I don't really too much bite into like what you know the new school do because mm-hmm. you know it's all South. You know, everybody got the da 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 da. You know, and you know I'm you know just a little West Coast kid. You know, from South Central. You know,
what high school?
Crenshaw.
Oh shit.
Wow.
To the yeah, show. I got kicked out in 2 weeks though, so that don't really count.
now you go up to school. Hey, bitches.
Nah, I really wasn't a, you know, type to want to go to class and stuff. Like, I stayed in the music class, you feel me?
Oh,
so
shit.
It's kind of shocking that, you know, I'm, you know, where I am today.
You play too? Music.
Of course.
Okay, what you play?
Organ, I play the drums, I could play the keyboard, you know.
Okay.
Damn. Now,
you know, do you predict, do
my
you play?
Family is talented.
That's cool.
Go ahead, P. You were saying?
Okay, no, I was going to say, do you play on your album? Do you play any instruments?
Of course. Of course. I'm playing a lot. You know, I'm doing a lot of, that's the main thing about me getting in the lab this time. It was just more so me focusing on myself. Like I said, the first side of NERU Take 5 is just me without anybody on it. It's just, you know, just all TEEFLII. Mm-hmm. And then the second side, you got, you know, the futures.
We have Sky in the building. She's a fan.
Sky,
of music.
Yeah.
You
I
have
know,
a question.
I was looking. I was like, damn, she looked familiar. And then I was like, that's Sky.
Where y'all know
Sky?
Each other from?
Sky High.
Hey, Sky.
Hey. I don't got no questions.
Yes, you do. Stop blushing. And ask the question.
Well, okay. What producers did you work with?
S-Bone. Just Josh. Futuristics, which is actually Mike and Keys. Myself.
Oh, you like, produced a lot?
Of course.
That's where the money is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Produce and...
I mean, a lot of people always hear me like on like the Mustard tracks and all of that. And like, that's a big thing that she even said that because, you know, my cousin is Bone, you feel me? So he's on this project, you know. He, you know, got out of jail. He started, you know, he turned his life around, you know. He, you know, making beats and everything. So to see him, you know, keep that, you know, focus and, you know, where he is right now, I'm proud of Big Bro.
How'd you get the name TEEFLII?
The streets.
He ain't gonna be around here long.
Yeah.
TEEFLII, that nigga. Hey, where my wallet? T gone.
T gone.
Damn, bounce.
Nah, actually, you know, it come from like dancing. You know, I grew up with, you know, the crump dancing. And,
oh, yeah.
You know,
oh,
the clown
shit.
Movement and all of that. So
Tommy the Clown?
No, I wasn't with Tommy, but I was. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Nigga, that's one dance that no older dude did. You couldn't crump near you or pull a motherfucker. You'd be like, all right, now good, I'm good, good. And little young nigga's like, that nigga locked that shit up. No.
But nah.
That, out, my nigga.
Nah, a lot of people have gotten hurt. I've seen, you know, stretchers.
I can imagine.
But, but Tommy is actually somebody that you could actually say that, like, showed, you know, greatness towards the young kids that was coming up, you feel me, such as myself. You know, still got into certain things, but it was always you had those kind of things that, you know,
could pull you away,
pull you away from, you know.
Now, what's
BS.
The song we have we're going to listen to?
Real Niggas.
Real Niggas?
Yeah, this produced by my cousin, too. This produced
Let
by
Let everybody
S-Bone.
Know where they can pick up the new CD. I know
oh,
it's
on
probably
iTunes.
Everywhere.
Ain't nothing coming out for free this time.
Buy some shit, bitch.
Back. Yeah.
And it's available this Friday?
This Friday.
And you got any shows coming up before we go?
No, I'm going to be accepting shows again, though, start of January.
Okay.
Social media?
If you need somebody to host a show.
You're too old, nigga.
Hey, nigga, I just start crumping. Y'all ready for T-Fly, motherfuckers? Oh, bitch-ass niggas, put your hands up.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Get your motherfucking hands up. Oh, no. Give it up for T-Fly.
Hey, I like the intro at first, but just the B word was kind of, I was like, yeah, you know. You know, somebody might take that offensive.
Hey, y'all ready to do this shit? We got T-Fly in the building. Let's get your hands together. Give it up for T-Fly.
All right.
That was more like a smooth Al Green intro.
So I need to be, get away from, okay, I'm ready now.
Okay, try one more time.
Turn up.
How many motherfuckers ready to do something?
We ready. Yay!
Show your love for T-Fly.
T-Fly, what's your social media?
TEEFLII.
On everything.
Yeah, okay. Everything. Well, on everything.
On everything.
We want to thank you for coming by. Looking forward to you.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I appreciate you guys.
Y'all scared the shit out of me when you got here first.
Me too.
I thought Poetess owed some money to some nigga. Shit. I'm gonna come get these cameras.
That's crazy you say that because a lot of people see me, they be like, man, you do not look like a singer, man. I thought you was a straight gunner.
I thought you was gonna grab him. I thought you was gonna come and go, hey, she ain't give me my money.
Nah, man, I'm a cool dude. You feel me? I really don't, you know, worry about too much. I love money, you know, and women.
Oh, okay.
Hey, good. That's a good order right there. Yeah. Because you got money, you get bitches.
not all the time. Some of these dudes is, you know.
Oh, yeah. Dude.
You know.
I mean, you got gift to
get. Cross your fingers, man. Cross your fingers. I'm trying to tell you, it's a lot of Frank Oceans in the ocean, Doc.
Oh,
bam.
Wow.
Shots fired.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Oh, that's on all this. That's on all the tape. So, you that's, you know.
So, the album drops this Friday.
Yeah.
Annie, are you Ote 5?
Yeah, right. It's the fifth one. It's the last one.
So, two-sided CD.
The last album or the last series of Annie?
Yeah, just the last series.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to get into the single, and we'll be back after don't move. This.
Hit it, Ronnie.
Ronnie?
Just
really?
Play.
That was
just
the gayest shit ever.
Yeah.
The fuck? Oh, wow. Shit. It was. I wasn't going to say it, though.
You gon' give it to me.
Give it to me.
Give it to me. Hey. I'm all up on your body.
Okay. We are back. It is the Rollout Show right here at Morris Media. It's your boy Speed Doggy Dog in the building. The funniest motherfucker you ever gonna meet. Fuck it. We don't even got to drop it. I'm gonna just say this one. Don't make excuses for nasty people. Sticking a flower is like sticking a flower in an asshole. You can't call it a vase.
Oh, wow. What?
Don't make excuses
Sandy,
for
like
nasty
that
people.
One?
You can't.
You can't put a flower in an asshole and call it a vase.
Okay.
Hey. Moving on.
But it serves as one.
You nasty.
Right. Oh,
no,
because
people always make excuses when nasty. You go in, go over a girl's house. You ever been to a girl's house, Ron? Not saying you would do that now, but in your other life. And you go over and they go, excuse. No, bitch, I'm not going to excuse none of this shit. You knew I was coming. Clean this shit up.
Wow.
What you look over here for?
Because there's a curtain on the other side.
I don't invite men to my house. Where your house at?
I don't women to my house. It's a little, look, it's a little complicated. I'll let you know when it comes to.
No, I don't. My house got to be clean before I have to.
What is that, Ryan?
You got to have a clean bathroom and a clean kitchen.
Yeah, I think if you want to know something about women, if they bathroom nasty,
yeah.
9 out of 10.
Who said if your, was it too short or somebody said if your car is nasty, your pussy dirty?
Wow, that's a little extreme. Yeah. It's a little extreme.
What if it's not nasty, it's just junky?
Yeah, mine's junky.
That's nasty. That's called nasty.
What about messy?
Yeah, we let our kids eat
just like clothes, papers.
Again, that's called nasty.
It's not nasty. It's having stacked up dirty dishes.
No, the first thing, no. The first thing somebody comes over your house to do is, can I use the restroom? You know that's coming.
Oh, well, that's different than having clothes.
Yeah, we're talking about the car.
Yeah, the car is different.
No, if I go in your bathroom and your bra is hanging and your underwear is clipped. Yes.
That's not nasty. How is that nasty? A bra hanging? You trying to dry
them? You go in the girl's bathroom and their drawers are hanging.
If they dirty.
They dirty, yeah. You're trying to dry them. You're like, some bras you can't put in the dryer, so you're going to hang them
up
over the shower.
But you know what? If I'm expecting a man to come over, I'm not going to have all that hanging in my bathroom. Yeah.
Nah, we just spread our bills out when y'all come over. Just.
Yeah, we do it like a poker hand. I'll take this one. No, I don't want that. I'll tell you this one. Is it, gas? Well, I do gas. Because gas, the gas bill, fellas, if you got to pay a bill, pay the gas bill. During the summertime, because the gas is real low, it'd be $49. I got
summertime.
You. Yeah. $49. I'm going to take care of that for you, baby. $49.50? Mm.
Thank you.
Don't do the DWP, though.
Power bill. Yeah, the power bill is the one.
You do that, motherfucker. You, nigga. If I pay you, I'll be like this. All right, so you sucking dick right now, right? Because I'm going to need my dick sucked to pay this shit. $400?
So, Speedy, that's all a girl had to do for you.
It sounds like it.
You like getting your dicks. Does Michelle do that? She don't do that, huh?
Oh, wow.
I shouldn't ask that question.
She's white.
I shouldn't answer the question.
She does it.
But, okay.
That's how she got him.
I apologize.
Oh, wow,
but does she still do it?
Really?
Wait till I say something.
Because, you know, you talk about how
we have a guest.
Our relationships change.
Hey there, Psychic Wayne is in the building.
You on.
No. No, put a card out. Put a card out. No, I just like it. I love that shit. But I like when you said, I just hug your dick while we just chilling.
Yeah, it's relaxing.
You don't understand.
Yeah.
Every dude, the two dudes in this motherfucker, Rock, it
Rock
not really Ron.
The room and shit.
Look, ladies, not really Ron, but
he's standing up.
I'm telling you, dudes across the country went, bless her heart.
But
because it don't happen like that for us. We don't. It don't. Most men.
Really?
Most men. It had to be, you know, okay, it's your
birthday, I guess. I just, shit.
Or it's like, all right, I'll do it. Nobody ever goes, what's it, Thursday? Let me go and suck your dick. It never happens. Or we walk in watching the game and you just pull the motherfucker out during the game and you ain't saying shit. You just, okay, hold me, pause this motherfucker. Nigga, what?
But
you don't know how much shit you would get. Ladies, you don't understand. Motherfucker will run to the mall.
Really?
This bitch wanted some perfume. I'm going to get the pump. I'm going to get the big ass pump of perfume. Oh,
but in the defense of the women, it's probably because when they go down on the men are like, grabbing the head.
Yeah, so that's a man thing.
Yeah, but no.
I have to make sure. No, I have to make sure I'm in control. Men want to still feel like we want to be able to go, mm-hmm, I made you so good. Mm-hmm. Right,
you're going to grab my head. I'm going to get up. You need to be focusing on the TV. Just relax. See if you can even ignore me.
Grabbing my head.
So it's
am
a
I
nope?
The only one sucking your dick? This is what I need to know. Once we get that out of the way, we good.
So you nigga, you need some working shifts. Let me get the third round. I get you at halftime. Let this bitch do you first. Right? See, that's
Kamara,
why you ain't got a man.
You gotta
enjoy it. You don't. She enjoys it.
Kamara say the shit that we thinking. That's why I like her so much.
You got to enjoy. That's your problem. You
no,
don't enjoy
she
what
don't
you're
have
doing.
To. That may not be her thing.
Oh, yeah, that ain't my thing.
Yes, it is. You want these bills paid? You spread the bills out, bitch.
Well, we can split them then. Fuck it.
Why you don't like it, Kamara? Because it's too much work?
No,
it's
not.
It is a lot of work.
No, you just can't trust a lot of dudes. So I don't.
No, let's say you trust them.
If I trust you, I'll suck your dick.
You don't like rocks.
See, I don't like how you said it like that. See, I'll suck your dick. No, I don't want you to get high in your voice. I'll suck your dick.
Shit.
I need you to be, just like Tangie said, I just do it just because today is the day.
Because today is
wisdom. If we like that, I will. Like, if we like that, if I be like, oh, I should do something sweet for him, and I know you just like that, then that's the sweet shit I'll do. Luckily, I would hope you would like to go to a football game or something, a Rams game. Something. I'd rather buy Rams tickets.
you sitting there
is
with
that
my
is that a good gift?
No, let me make sure I got this right. So you got my dick and tickets. Dick. I don't want to suck his dick. I buy some tickets.
I hope it means the same, too.
No.
Speedy, would that be a good gift?
Yeah.
Tickets to your man's favorite football team?
Yes. Yes. And like, if y'all go and tailgate and you hook that up, like, we going to go to my boy's Rock.
Oh, and we can cook?
And we go to, you hook it up where we going to cook on the tailgate and then go in the game, nigga, you get so much dick. You don't understand, P.
Really?
Is that Speedy all want extra?
No, that's it, bitch.
I get that anyway.
No, not you. You getting cool dick.
Extra.
You do that shit there, nigga. Grow an inch. Mm. What was that? Mm-hmm. See, you bought me some tickets, bitch. See, you stupid. Yeah, that's extra shit. Now, Psychic Wayne's in the building.
What's up, Psychic?
Hey, Psychic Wayne.
Them donuts or cars? What the fuck is that?
Those are the cars.
Oh, man. It's the cars.
Why is it in a donut box?
That's the box that came in. But I
missed the bag.
Speedy's hungry.
I actually
don't mind.
You got the Crown Royal bag? Hey man, I got.
I'm ratchet.
You know, I'm surprised what I got in the Crown Royal bag. So what's happening today? You know, people mad at you.
Yeah, they mad at you.
Oh, that's fine.
Okay.
The first thing go ahead. Oh.
No,
I was saying that our fans were like, "Ah, I thought Hillary was going to win."
Mm-hmm.
Well, she did win, sort of.
Well, here it is. First of all, just because I got a prediction wrong doesn't mean astrology doesn't work. Doesn't mean I don't know what I'm doing. I'm human, and that election, I was so emotionally, I just couldn't imagine this man winning. I can't predict what I can't imagine.
Yeah,
but you know, and I was wrong. I'm not covering that up or trying to make an excuse, but she won the popular vote by 2.5 million.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't ask, well, will she win the electorate and not the popular? Mm-hmm. I just asked if she's going to win. So in a way, she did win. Mm. So, yeah.
And they could have cheated. We never know.
So and it don't matter now because he is.
Well, he's in there. He's in there. And I have other colleagues that do what I do. Mm-hmm. You know, they're doing all this stuff about, you know, they think he's going to be assassinated. I don't participate in all
that. No, don't say that.
Is that in the cards?
No, it's not. Hey, it's not. No, Pam. I turn this mic off.
I just accept it.
Scott.
But for real, my spirit is feeling like I'm not.
Stop!
No, what?
No. I don't want to be that popular. Don't want to show that popular.
I know, but I'm saying, my spirit does feel like it's not. It still doesn't feel real to me. Like, so I think that it might not be real. Like, you know. Like, maybe he will, like, get impeached. Well, not assassinated.
Okay, we'll go with impeached.
Okay, here's my thing. I've become so jaded
to
it.
Why y'all don't want him assassinated?
No, we don't. Stop.
I'm just asking.
God be blessing me, so I don't want to mess mine up. That's personally why I don't want him assassinated.
I'm not saying I wish it on personal.
Don't even mention that shit on this fucking show. We'll be famous for the wrong fucking reason. All right, so I've become so just disconnected with everything. I don't even watch the news no more. I don't want to know what I don't want to know about the cabinet members. Like, it'll pop up on my tablet and because I don't want to know. Because I'm like, whatever happens to America, this is what you wanted. So get in line, accept what you're supposed to get, and be happy when you walk away. That's all.
And you know what? Can I just say this? Usually, a big prediction like that, I do a lot of different charts.
Mm.
I didn't look at the United States chart. This country has a chart, mm-hmm. You know, born in cancer or whatever. When I looked at that chart, it definitely showed this major change, and not to talk in astrology terms, but Saturn is right over the ascendant. Saturn has to do with a new structure, a new way of life.
Yes.
So the people that he's putting in, it really is going to affect us in some kind of way.
They're all billionaires. They know nothing about the country.
I couldn't believe it when I looked at that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. They're mostly millionaires and billionaires who are pretty much are going to line their pockets after all this is done, because that's what the Bushes did. That was the whole reason for going to war, is that they're able to line their pockets with, now you got to buy shit from my uncle's company, from this company, this, that, and the other. People don't understand how this shit works.
I never thought it would be a Trump dynasty. You know, the Bushes, the Clinton.
Yeah.
I just never even could imagine that.
Now his family's set for the rest of their life because, yes. You know, anyway. So what you got for us today? And
oh, well, you know, we can take calls, but I'm tired of talking about Kanye and Kim.
Okay, no Kanye and Kim calls.
But the situation with that is not good. I saw that coming a while ago, because
mm-hmm.
he's having a total mental breakdown, and that relationship is about to come to an end.
It is.
Y'all can hold me to that.
Because they said they was living separately, so it didn't surprise me.
I know, that's sad.
It is sad, you know, because really the way their charts work together, they really were in love. But, you know, sometimes things, yeah.
They didn't seem happy, though, did they?
Well, you know, I think that they were into each other. I just think that this public life and all the money and stuff is hard. It's hard.
It's hard to live under that. People don't understand. They think you got money, you got a little power, that you're happy. And that's not necessarily.
Because the people that don't have money think, if I had it, I'd be happy.
No, that's not happy.
I feel sad for them, because I think there's two different forms of crazy in our worlds. I think white crazy and black crazy is a little different.
Yeah, when you're black crazy, your family don't fuck with you.
And I think that, I think.
Don't let that crazy nigga in here. Shit.
I hope that they don't think that he's so crazy where they start to fear Kanye. And then Kanye can't be around his kids and stuff, because that'll just make him, I think.
Well, that's what. See, white people flip it like that.
You know what I'm saying? Like. Because sometimes people don't understand. He's a black man. Like, they are. Like, sometimes I have to be like, damn. Like, you know what I'm saying? These niggas is sensitive. What are they like? Y'all go through a lot. And it's crazy. I was just riding with my, you know, because I don't have a car.
Mm-hmm.
One of my homeboys took me.
For the 15th time.
Whatever. And he taking me home. But my homeboy drove me somewhere. And when I mean we obeyed every damn law, like people was honking at him, like, you could go now.
Really?
And I was like, is it this stressful being a black man driving? Yeah. Like, I mean, the nigga damn near put a signal on and signaled his hand out the window. He did not want to get pulled over. Like,
not going to jail today.
I was stressed out. Like, I'll drive. I'm going to be late. Like, I'm going
to
drive.
And when you try to explain that to young black men that y'all don't understand, they don't want you to grow up and be anything. Mm-hmm. They want you to go to jail. Hopefully they get you in a situation where you have to plead guilty to some raggedy
shit.
Yes. And they go, nah, it ain't gonna happen to me. Okay, all right, nigga.
Yeah.
And when they do, I'll be right here with the tarot cards going, see right here, nigga? See the cuffs?
So I just hope they understand that part. That's
it's handcuffs on the skeleton, nigga. That means you go to jail.
Right, for real.
So, Bruce, you don't have to talk about that because you said you're done
who's
with them.
Bruce?
But
who, Bruce?
She calls me by my
yeah.
Nigga,
I said, who the hell is Bruce?
Like Bruce Wayne.
I'm sorry. Sorry. It came all out of nowhere, too.
I hate when motherfuckers act like they know you personally. Hey, look here, Carl. Fuck is Carl? His nigga's name is C. Chuck. I hate you, Sandy. And then she lit it.
So, Bruce.
She don't
know nobody. She gonna grab the microphone on slide.
I call him Bruce. Oh, our bad. We knew it before you, but okay.
Think about it. As a matter of fact, when you correct me, I was like, oh, is that his name? Did I get his name wrong? But, yeah, so.
But go ahead.
Okay. So, I know you don't want to talk about it today, but on your Instagram account, at some point, could you let us know if you think that they're going to try to get funny with his children? Because I hadn't thought about what she just said, and I'll pray for him.
Oh, yeah. Well, absolutely. For white folks, that's what they do.
Yeah, and that would
they,
be rude. That
if you
want to
hurt, if you wanna hurt most black men, you go, you can't see your kids. Like, yeah, you ain't gonna, or you can see them when the courts say, and the courts get in there. And
I don't believe that. And, you know, with all the money she has, he has, his attorneys are not going to let that girl just take those kids.
Mm-hmm. So
but if you put him under the crazy banner.
Yeah, that's what I was worried about.
They got proof.
Yeah. When you one thing I'm gonna tell you, black people, don't ever check yourself in, because it's hard to get out the crazy house.
Well, you know, in Kanye's chart, he was born with Jupiter next to the sun. Those are the two biggest planets in the galaxy, and that's why his ego is just so way off the chart. And his daughter was born with the same thing.
So she better keep him around, because the daughter gonna have
yeah. She's gonna be very egotistical too. I couldn't believe it inside.
So you got the card. That okay? Well, I mean, I'm
because I'm new. Because okay,
Look, talk to Bruce.
Because my name Kamira. My name Kamira Matilaba Wells White, and I'm an Aries.
So
what's your question? What do you want to know about career, love, what?
I want to know it all. Can I get like a summary?
You want a gumbo soup?
Like, yeah.
Career, relationship.
I feel like I'm going to be wealthy. I just feel it ever since I was little.
Hold on, don't feel shit till the cards come out.
I feel very spiritual. I feel connected to people. I'm very empathetic. I feel people's spirit. I really do. Let's get an answer to a question.
I ain't never seen a motherfucker go, I like me.
No, because I am so
that's what
I
know.
I'm
too.
Just playing with. I'm just playing.
No, but you want to know what?
I'm so ready.
A specific question.
You have to ask a question.
Will you have a? Will she find a man next year?
Not next year. It's gonna take a minute. I know. I'm difficult.
So go with the career.
Okay. Will I have a successful career? And
in the drive-thru?
Will I have a successful career? And will I eventually? I want to make my parents proud. That is like I really do, because I have the greatest parents, and sometimes I feel like I'm not the greatest child.
Your dad is a little.
Your dad is.
So he crazy. But
I bet they're already proud of you. They just.
I bet you
with
they
you.
Are.
So I just want to make them proud and make my daughter proud and be successful in my life.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. He didn't shovel them. He didn't shovel the paint off them.
But I was trying to pull her energy. That's what I was trying to do. Why are you so bitter when it comes to men?
For real. Yeah, that was first card that came out.
It did.
It was a bitter dude going, bitch.
Is that true, Kamira?
Yeah.
We didn't just meet her. I mean,
yeah, we do. We've been knowing her for a while.
Yeah.
So when it comes to your career, there's definitely been a struggle. There's some discouragement right now. You got the Justice card, which I like, because what the Justice card means is the effort you put in, you get a reward. I think you've been trying, but you're going to have to up the trying at this point. And you know what? I think probably in less than 6 months, there's something that's going to open your eyes about what you haven't been doing in order to get the career thing off of the ground.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I think that also, I mean, your mother is in here, which means she supports you, and you know, she doesn't feel like you're a failure or anything. I don't know if you think that, but
not her daddy.
Well, your mom is here, so I think that she's very supportive. She's waiting for you to, you know, to do what it is that you want to do. So that's good. I just need you to put forth extra effort. If you've been putting forth this much effort, you're gonna have to do it here and then meet in the middle.
He good.
That's what justice is about.
So back to the man. Why is she so bitter now? That was the bitter card, I'm sure, right?
No. Right? The first one. Card that's
yeah,
out.
Dude look
that,
like
that could
a
also represent
person.
A man that really hurt you that's still kind of in your spirit and in your heart.
Right across the street. It's my dad. Well, we have this sort of, it's like a love. He loves me, but the way he expresses it is harsh. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like,
right.
He wants me to be the best, but the way he tells me is like, you ain't the best.
Because some people, especially back then, they thought just say it, maybe this will motivate the person more so than now you got to take it on the chin like, okay, nigga. Because my dad was that way.
Yeah.
My mother be like, "Don't worry, that boy was good. That nigga ain't shit. He ain't gonna never be shit." I'm like, "I'm right here."
But I think when it comes to men, because of him, I overcompensate in my relationships trying to look for that validation. Aww. But then it doesn't happen, so it makes me bitter because I'm like, I do everything.
Yes. Okay, well, you got to do something different to get a different result. If you know you're doing the same thing and the same thing is happening, that may be part of what they're saying. You're going to open your eyes to what you've been doing and change it and do something different in order to get that next result.
Okay.
You know?
We got to go on somebody else. I'm getting a little.
Hold on. Thug bitches can't cry. You can't be like. You got to do like this.
Cut the camera.
Come here. You got to do like this. Is it raining in
this place? Well, come on in, Rock, so he can feel your energy.
He want to know if his hair going to grow today.
Oh, wow. Rock lost some weight. Have y'all noticed?
No, I found it. It's right here.
No, come over here near me. And then might want you to touch him. I don't
lean
know.
Over a dude. That's not good.
All right. So what's your question, Rock?
I want to know what my purpose is.
Oh, now, wow.
To clean up, nigga.
You know, like,
oh, my bad.
I've never had a job where, I mean, I've done everything. I don't have one specific thing that I'm good at. I do everything.
Are you about to cry?
No.
No, you had to.
I was about to cry. I wasn't going to lie. I was about to cry.
Lord Jesus, let him get a card that works.
A natal chart, but we'll see what the cards have to say, because the natal chart can talk about, like.
And what is a natal chart?
Are you going to make, you know, the astrology charts.
Oh, the charts.
Where are you going to make your mark in life? But we can ask the cards to say, what's your birthday?
May 23rd.
My baby's birthday. They got my daughter's birthday.
Oh, shit, they finna bond.
Gemini.
There you go. Your eyes are open.
Put into three stacks towards you. Is that your left hand? Yeah. There you go.
It's the other left.
The left on the right.
Yeah, the left on the right.
Yeah.
How old are you?
35. How old are you?
20.
Dog ears.
Well, you do. You definitely got many talents, but you haven't figured out one or two. Did you go to school?
Mm-mm.
Huh?
Yes.
You finished?
Yeah, I'm finished, but I still got some more to do.
What are you waiting
then
on?
You ain't finished yet.
Yeah, I'm finished.
Because I got a degree, but I can go higher.
He's going,
but
he's saying you can go more.
Oh, well, this talks about you going back to school or something having to complete your career. It has to do with some other kind of training. Even if you don't go back to get another degree, it's something about you being trained. What's interesting to me in this chart, I mean, in these cards, is that you have some really strong positive cards. These cards, you got justice, you got the world, and the Ace of Wands. What they're trying to tell us is that whatever your purpose is, it's a big purpose, meaning that people are going to know what you do. So I don't know that I can find that for you. You got to find this. What have you been thinking about doing? Because your mark in life is definitely not being met. You're 35. That's not old in 2016. Now, in the 80s and 70s, 35 is kind of up there. But what have you been thinking about doing?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to pick out a career for you, but right, what I can tell you is that whatever your mark in life is, it has to do with people knowing who you are.
DJ? So.
Don't feel, I mean, Geminis are a jack of many trades, like really.
Yeah, he not got a lot of talent.
What did you get a degree in?
I'm marine biology.
Wow.
Let me guess, your daughter's in marine biology.
I went to school for marine biology.
She
shut up. You ain't went to school for shit. You know
what? What school did you go to? USC. I went to Hampton. Oh, he went to real school.
But she did say, hey, but she did say she did study biology.
Remember she was a marine biologist? And you was clowning me? I went to Hampton for a marine biologist degree. What are you talking about? I wanted to be a marine biologist. But okay.
Fuck.
I did.
You need your chart, buddy, because you can't let this just go away. Talking about you don't know where. You can't. And also, if you're Gemini, you're ruled by Mercury. Mercury rules the mind. So, I mean, you're blessed with that kind of communication and that kind of intelligence. You got to figure this out.
You're just good at everything. Nothing wrong with that. You just got to figure out what you love.
And you got a dog dick. So, I mean, you got shit to work with. You got some avenues to fulfill.
That is amazing. He has
Ron,
my daughter's
you want to get in there, Ron?
He said he don't want
to
do it.
It's so good, though, to know once you figure it out, it's going to be something really powerful.
Well, yeah. My birthday's on the 20th. Let's do, I guess.
Pam, we know about you.
You waiting for it to happen? Yeah. No, it ain't never going to happen. You waiting for it to happen. You got to go out to the ship.
Just like he just told her.
Because you really do have a gift, and that's what they're saying. Once this gift is found, it'll be big. So you know.
What do you like to do?
You don't know.
He was on point with mine.
Sleep.
Yeah, I'll do your chart for you, and see really what at the moment you were born, what kind of real purpose that you know.
Because we all have a purpose.
Exactly.
Yes, life,
we
right?
all do. I do too, because I was told at 19 that I was going to be doing this. I was like, they're crazy. I'm in college. I'm going to be in corporate America. Okay. And now that I can read a natal chart, it's right there. So.
But how did you know you could read? It just kind of came to you?
With the cards?
Yeah.
No, my aunt used to show me or whatever, and okay. just kind of went from there when I was small. I hid it for many years, you know, because black people have this issue with it, and they think it's this and that, so I didn't talk about
especially
it.
You're trying to read regular deck cards.
All right, this ace of spades right here, bro.
This means you're dark.
Actually, they can be read.
See?
These cards. So. Fuck. They can?
Oh. Playing cards came from these cards.
Wow.
When I was in Saudi Arabia, there was a lady that used to read coffee.
Yeah, I've seen people read coffee grinds and stuff like that.
Because the ace of spades is actually the ace of swords. Spades of swords, hearts of cups, that kind of thing.
Astrology goes all the way back to
ancient Egypt. I don't
need
the biologist to tell me about the cards. You focus on your books.
I'm just saying.
How about that?
You need to study the oxygen.
You need to suck more dick. How about that?
So, Wayne, what about on the 20th? When people read bones, have you?
That's not a good one.
Shake the bones up and.
I don't want to be there for that one.
That's not in my genre.
Have you heard of it? It's like Yoruba.
Like Africans. Yeah,
Africans be doing it.
Yeah. From the religion. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they definitely do. They do human bones. Yeah.
Human bones.
But somebody had to donate them. Somebody had to go and put my elbow in.
No, you know, like in Cuba and all of that stuff.
Yeah.
They don't bury the people right away. They store them. So, you know, people can take the bones and do whatever
and
they want
to
do.
And then read them? It was a little late, ain't it?
Yeah.
Come over. What's that smell? That's
take
that's
the bones
grandmama.
Of the dead person and read the dead person, or you bones? Take the dead person's bones and read Speedy's?
No.
You know, like, do you take the dead? Is like, if Speedy wants me to read him, mm-hmm. would I go in there and get the bones from the dead
Why
person
do we have
and say
to explain
this about Speedy? Or is it the dead person that you're reading?
I don't
I'm
think
a Gemini,
that.
Ruled by the mind,
they
Mercury.
Collect bones, they collect bones. They use these bones, they put them in a bag, and then what they do is when they drop the bones, they see the reading.
So I can read Speedy with somebody else's
not
dead
you.
Bones. Gotcha.
All right.
Damn. Sure. So it's probably a little bit more.
Yeah, it's more complex.
She just
complex.
Wanted to know if she had to get your bones or something.
Okay, Pam.
Speedy.
Since my birthday's on the 20th, we're going to do a career one.
Oh. Pam's birthday is on the 20th.
Now, Pam does this every time. Every
Party
time he
17.
Come in, Pam go, well, I'm thinking about the third. What you got?
That's not
I do
true.
This every time. Left hand, please. Big ass mitts.
Got it.
Uh-oh. Something hanging out.
The lovers.
Hilarious.
Oh, hey.
We said Korea.
She been loving.
Ooh.
Palm Springs.
Look, she blushing.
Let's see.
Yeah, okay. Right now you got a full house.
Do we want to ask Sean to turn off the radio for a second?
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, turn
Sean,
radio.
Could you turn it off
yeah,
for a second?
If anybody out there wants a reading, call in.
Yeah, call in.
293-3375.
Okay, so let me ask you this. What do you have, since the last time we talked,
mm-hmm.
are you doing something different from the career or for the career than before?
No.
What do you mean? Am I doing something different? Like if
you know, you, we talked about your,
yeah, career. I was doing TV and I'm trying to get away from it. Yeah.
Why?
Because I don't know.
That's crazy. That's the card of walking away. I was trying to figure out what this means. Why do you want to walk away? Because you're discouraged?
Because working for networks and for other people and stuff, like you have a 2-3 year thing and then they lay you off or they do something else. And it just got frustrating because I'm smarter than those people. So
it's time for you to fight back. Look at that. The warrior woman. You can't let them run you out of that business. Apparently there's like a place in this situation for
really?
You. Why would you do that?
Or because I just got discouraged with it because it's been a lot. Africa Channel took the life out of me. They were just the stupidest. I'm going to say it right. They were stupid, unprofessional, didn't know what they were doing.
Don't let them take the life out of you. But anyway, my question to Pam is, what is it ideally that you would like to do and make a living at doing?
Run my own network. Run a network.
Oh, shit, nigga, you better get started.
Because, look, the Africa Channel is still going to be on, making money, whatever, and you, like, you let them spoil you or turn you away from this.
Mm-hmm.
Look, there's still effort and time, and there's even a contract card in here. So you haven't tried to go to any other networks because of the African network?
Well, just the whole thing from Fox. I mean, I've launched 5 networks. I've helped to launch and been built some traffic systems and stuff like that, and it's just been a lot going on.
Because I know her story. You could have asked me. I built 5 networks. I worked at the Africa Channel. They didn't like me. I didn't like the motherfuckers either. I had to wear a dashiki on Thursday.
Yeah, so that's really what
all of that. All of that wisdom and knowledge that you
have a lot of it.
That's insane.
Let him tell you.
For you to walk away from it, like, forget about it. I think that the reason you had those opportunities was for you to gain all that knowledge and then for you to take it to another level and do what you're supposed to do.
All right.
Because we all need to be on TV, Pam.
No, we didn't. Bitch, don't hold us back because you tired and lazy.
We have a call.
You're a star.
Call it with your name and where you call it from.
I'll hear dashiki.
Call it with your name and where you call it from.
Flii from Oakland.
Hey, what's your question for Wayne?
Hi, I have questions about career and relationships.
Okay, I'll answer one for you since we don't have a lot of time. What's your question?
Okay.
Oh, yeah, who is that? Or is hers? Is your radio up or something?
Oh, no, we good. There we go. Okay. All right. So we do what? Okay. Career?
Career.
Career.
Okay.
What's your question for me?
I would like to make a transition. I just want to know if maybe you can see a transition in this.
All right. I'm sorry. Give me your birth date again.
2/20/1980.
All right.
Brand new baby.
Mm-hmm.
Sure, I got some Jordans on there.
Wow. Are you really?
Really?
1981.
Really? That's where we at, y'all?
Sweet
That's where
babies. We at,
man. Yep. Transition here. A new beginning. Something. Learning something new. I got to tell you, relationships have been way too important for you. How old are you?
Baby.
36.
Yeah, you waiting on him and waiting on love and that kind of stuff is kind of taking some of the spike out of you going forward with your career. A change is good. In fact, it's so good that this is speaking here about a lot more money than you've made in two. Hello?
No, you're good.
Another call.
I was about to say hello.
We don't have extra lines.
Yes. Make the change. Relationships need to either be balanced or not at all right now because it takes away from you. It's been taken away from you.
Is this true, caller?
Yes.
You feel you put relationships priority over your career?
Oh, I definitely put more effort
into the relationships.
This person that I'm with now. So.
Oh, wow.
In other words, put the dick down and go on to work. Leave the dick alone.
The energy is going to be right for you to gain something new or to start something new as far as a new job, a new opportunity, or what have you. So I need you to at least be balanced and not give the relationship all in all.
Okay.
Thank you for the phone call. Now, in that is it like, so the person like not go out that much with that person? Or when you say focus more on the career and not on...
If there's something they were supposed to be doing that is career and they decide to go to the movies with, oh boy, or whatever, then don't do that. Do what you, put you first is what he's saying.
Well, you got to be balanced with it. The reason I knew this is because we're asking about work and a relationship is what the cars are trying to talk to me about.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We didn't ask
about a relationship. We asked about her work. Mm-hmm. But then, you know, let's talk about something new coming. And that's why I said, she's putting that in front of her.
So in a sense, though, are you telling that or whoever it may be that, like you said, is it that, okay, instead of focusing on
him,
that guy, and making sure he happy, make sure you're happy, and then go to him second.
Right. Or at very least, be sure that you're doing what you're supposed to do to advance yourself, and then weekends, hang out with
him. Because as women, we tend to make decisions of putting them first before our career, whatever.
Except the dick is good.
When I was anyway, we have another call.
Bad dick make you focus.
What happened, you guys? I don't hear myself. Okay, caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
I don't hear myself.
Yeah, turn me up.
Kim, I'm calling from Cleveland.
Hey
Kim, what's your question for
Cleveland,
Wayne?
How you doing?
I want to know, am I going to be in a relationship soon? I've been single too long.
Mm. How long you been single?
Do you suck dick?
Oh, wow, really? Really, I've been single for 6 years.
Okay.
Somebody's headphones are louder near the mic.
Is it me?
No. All
right. You're staring at me.
I ain't moved.
Is it me?
Not all we own. You can turn it. Okay, go. All right. Okay. So what's your date of birth, right?
Birthday is January 3rd.
Okay, so it's been 6 years since you had a relationship?
Yep.
All right. I hope she has some dick up in there.
Right.
I think the dick card just came out.
God damn, a long time.
Cam, you there? That's your name?
Yes.
It's her name, yes. Cam.
Oh, okay. I gotta tell you, in the relationships in the past, you've been really kind of aggressive to the point where you don't trust men. You make accusations and that kind of thing. Looking at this, it just talks about the past and how you've kind of surrounded yourself with the thoughts that nobody can be trusted, and that's not really true. Mm-hmm. Now, the good thing about it is that there is a relationship coming. How old are you? You said.
45.
You're young.
Okay. You got kids? You got a daughter?
No.
You don't have any? Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, he's talking about a little girl. Look, let me just tell you. I don't think when I look at your cards and I look at the card that tells me what you've been doing to meet somebody, there's just not a lot here. And you also live in the past, you know? So if you're asking me, are you going to meet somebody soon? I think, yeah, you can meet somebody soon. You could have already met somebody, but it just hasn't happened because you haven't really, really participated in the situation that can make this happen. Mm. Let me ask you, the last relationship you were in, what happened?
He was married and he didn't tell me.
Mm. Yeah, that make me angry. I'd be a little angry.
Yeah.
Camille's getting angrier right now. She want to beat that nigga.
Yeah, I bust his wings.
So I did.
That's my girl. That's my dog.
Bust a window, ask questions later.
That's what this card does.
I seen that card. Bust your window.
What is that? What is that card?
That's the Maiden of Swords. You do her wrong, she's gonna get you. And see, that's the thing the point that I was making is that I feel like, you know, when you do meet this person, you can't be thinking in terms of what has happened to you before, because that was pretty bad. And you still feel that 6 years later, you still feel that hurt from it. Okay, and you got the King of Cups coming, which means this person that's not light skinned but dark skinned. I don't know if that's your preference, but
I like them high yellow.
Yay!
Yeah,
it doesn't matter.
No, well, good.
So let the past go, baby.
Let the past go. And then it sounds
don't
like
bust no more windows. Don't put no tracking device on the phone. Don't show up to his mama house.
And
don't
run. I think really the message here is definitely you are going to meet somebody, but when you meet somebody, you can't be like this. You can't be like, you know, thinking that everybody's going to do you wrong.
Hey, Beck, can I use the bathroom? I'm going with you. In the bathroom? Thank you for the phone call, baby girl.
Thank you.
We'll take one more call.
Don't tell us the fuck we going to do. We read the card. We'll read you.
Will Speedy be here next year?
It ain't in the card.
Oh, it's all blank. I don't know what the fuck this means.
We have another call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Hey, Rollout. This is Jessica. I'm calling from Atlanta.
Hey, Jessica.
Bring your chipper down.
Like she had a good day today. You got some dick this morning, Jessica? Like, hey.
I said, hey, Rollout.
See?
How you doing, baby?
I'm good, and yourself?
I'm doing great.
What's your question for Wayne, and when's your birthday?
Birthday's April 15th, 1994.
Why do I know an Aries when I hear one? Hey, boo.
Hey, Samira.
And your question is what?
about my career, just should I stay in? I love what I do, but I'm kind of bored with it.
Okay.
I want to go elsewhere.
All right. Well, let's.
So you don't like strip club? Cool.
if I got rid of this belly, I might have been.
Oh shit, dog. Belly is good. Seems something. I need something to hold on to when I'm hitting from behind.
Make a strip club called Belly.
So you know exactly what you're getting when you walk in. Hey, these bitches is pregnant. What's that?
Welcome to Bellas. I'm Maggie.
Hot wings on sale.
They put the order on their stomach. What you want? Two chicken wings?
That ain't what I ordered, bitch.
All right, what you got?
Oh, what was your name?
Jessica. Okay, from Atlanta.
Okay, even though you like this job, this is not what you're meant to be doing, and you know that. You need to step outside this comfort zone, because the truth of it is that once you kind of feel, once you figure out where it is you want to go, what it is you want to do, you got the wish card, which means it's going to happen for you. Mm. How long have you been at this present job, and is your supervisor a woman?
At the moment, yes. I'm a truck driver. I've been doing it for about 4 years now, and I love it, but it was supposed to just get me back on my feet, but I fell in love with it.
Right.
And now I'm just doing it, but I kind of hate it.
Well, no, it's a way that you make a living and you don't mind doing it. Right. And what's going to happen? What's going to happen here? Since you got the wish card, you need to figure out what you want to do, because it says whatever it is you want to do, you're going to kind of fall into it, but you got to figure that out. Even though you can drive the trucks until you retire, but you're going to still feel the same way you're feeling right now. It's a job. It's not really the career that you really genuinely want.
Right.
You know? I don't know what a woman has to do with your job. Does a woman own it, or what is that?
She's just my dispatcher. I don't know. That's.
You don't like that bitch. Just saying. You don't like that bitch calling you.
You missed your pickup, bitch. You missed a load.
Bitch, you better lower your voice on this phone.
Jessica, I'm going to tell you this too. You know, in the next couple of years or so, you may actually start doing it on your own.
Mm. Yep. I've been battling with that. I feel like I know enough, but I've seen so many people fail that I'm scared to step out and do it.
Well, that's where the magic happens.
Well, read this new Steve Harvey book, because he talks about that.
Right.
Well, Aries people, we are scared. We're scared to fail. That's like a big thing with us.
Well, I think that's every sign, but okay.
But I mean, I don't know, but it's especially like, it's like the backlash.
Thank you
all
for
of
your
it.
Call.
Yeah, thank you for your call. Scared to fail?
Yeah, I mean, because they
got to step out there, man.
Aries is about the ego.
Mm-hmm. And Virgos?
They don't want to look bad.
And Virgos?
What about Virgos?
Do they have egos?
Yes. We think we know it all.
Because he
does. Well, let me explain that to you real quick. Real astrology incorporates all the signs depending on what time you were born. Okay. Mm-hmm. Even though she's an Aries.
I was in the womb, so I wouldn't know what time I came out.
Yeah, my first house and second house.
The sun was in Aries when you were born, but you got a moon sign, you got an ascendant, you got a descendant, you got all of that. You know, and some people like me, I'm a Leo, but I got planets in Libra. So I'm kind of Libran with my Leo. So it's just kind of a mix. And that's why people don't genuinely believe astrology, because they know not every Pisces is the same, or not every Aries is the same.
I believe all Sagittarius.
Yeah, because broke Pisces and rich Pisces don't go together.
What's that?
That's some real shit.
That's some real shit. Thank you, Wayne. How do people, if they want to reach you for their own, they want us fucking with them with jokes and shit?
I know, right?
Sure. Fuck, you can hit me up at my site at psychicwayne1.com, psychicwayne1.com, or call me at 1-888-929-6307. That's 1-888-WAYNE07. You also can get your daily horoscope on Facebook at Psychic Wayne, and you can follow me on Instagram at Psychic Wayne 1.
What about Bruce? Can we talk to him?
You talking to him?
Because I got a lot of stuff coming up.
No, you don't. Apparently not. You need to focus.
Did your movie open?
It comes out in June, but we finished it. And yeah, you did predict that. Thank you.
Okay, well, that's good. I would like to also, you know, at some point, I ask you for your data, your birth date. I would like to see how that's going to turn out for you.
Do it now. Do we have time?
Well, I don't.
You said you don't know what time you were born.
I have to cast a chart.
You said he was going to. Remember, we were supposed to. Well, yeah, it takes we were supposed time. To
how do I find out when I was born?
Birth certificate, Speedy. Birth certificate, Speedy. Birth certificate.
April 7, 1:32
I have it with me.
Morning.
I have a birth certificate with me.
I'm all into astrology.
I have to cast it in my software. 11, 17,
okay, I'll give it to you. Okay. Yeah, I carry all my shit with me just in case it go bad. When the police ask me, do you have birth certificate? Hold on. I got everything with me. Really? Nigga robbed me. They
Who
came up.
Who has their birth certificate with them?
Hey, you never know.
You must have another copy. You lose that, then you got to go through a lot to get it.
I'm not going to lose it. I don't lose shit. I never lose.
Yeah, especially that. Way back when they have.
Hold up, bitch. Took my shit on a tablet? Jesus wrote your birthday. You were born at Descending 3.
Your shit in a file cabinet is what I'm saying.
Well, fuck you.
Like, it's not digital, is what
yeah,
you
it's
said.
It's not digital.
That's what they call black people color.
You gotta go to a. Where they purge the information, dig through it, get your shit, then. I'm sorry. I'm just.
Hey, you know what? Also, can I say something really quick?
Gotta go to the hospital.
Yes.
About, well, people, you know, it's Christmas time, so we're supposed to be celebrating the birthday of Jesus. So, do y'all know that he's not really a Capricorn?
Yeah,
right?
he's
nigga,
born
did
in
you
the
just say Jesus
right?
wasn't a Capricorn?
Early spring.
I'm very upset that he ain't a Capricorn.
So he was Aries?
He's a Pisces.
Yeah, it's
Pisces.
I heard he was
like, what my baby. Huh? Like
what was he born? April?
My
was it mom. April?
No, they don't know the exact day.
Oh, okay. I thought it was a month. I mean, they might know.
No, it was late. It was early spring. But I was going to say that people don't understand how they like to condemn the astrology, condemn what I do. But you know what the fish, the Christian symbol, is because he was Pisces.
Right. Okay.
Yeah. I knew that.
I never heard nobody put it that way. Nigga, you know Jesus wasn't a Capricorn. And like, I was going to go, God damn. That's that bullshit, man.
Not a Capricorn.
Yeah, go, shit.
Capricorn. I can imagine Jesus being a Pisces because Pisces are empathetically just amazing, sweet.
Thank you.
They're
loving.
They're selfless, compassionate.
Thank you.
All of that. They
Thank
heal.
You.
And all
jealous.
Of that. And
Thank
that's
you.
What his
Thank
ministry
you,
was about.
Poetess, that's right. That's right. Because they got the other side, too.
Yeah, he was jealous.
Yeah, they got the other side.
All right, Pam, give you information. Nice jacket.
At Nikki Pam on everything with 2 K's. Buy a shirt.
Bitch.
That's why Tandy and Speedy got them on. Buy it for Christmas for your niggas, but whatever it is.
Your man.
Rolloutshow.com. I actually am taking another $5 off. God damn it. What else do you need?
Yeah, buy a t-shirt. Suck the dick as you buy the t-shirt.
Oh, wow.
Speedy is funny on everything. That Speedy IZ funny on everything. Buy a t-shirt, bitch. If you can't buy a t-shirt, tell somebody about the show.
And have them buy a t-shirt.
Have them buy a t-shirt. And buy one for your boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever it may be. Yeah. Come here.
Tell them it's the funniest show you're ever going
to hear. Yeah, and not only buy a t-shirt, donate to the show. Y'all forgot.
Yeah.
Donate to the show, Morris Media, GoFundMe.com. See, Porters, I'll be late, but I remember my cues.
Thank you. I'm glad I'm the only one that doesn't have to
I hate when
say
you
it.
Do that. See? If I had the information in front of me, I would say it.
Why is everything about you?
Hold on.
Oh,
you heard what the fuck? Give me a
call. Why is everything about you?
Wayne, give me a call.
I ain't even talking about you. I'm thanking Kamara and Tangie because both of them.
She out here, she do it.
I don't like you sitting there because your eyes are kind of right above the screen, and I feel like I can't see your mouth, and I just see your eyes staring. That's not cool. I need you to slide over. Sky, get up. Fuck y'all doing. I don't like this look.
Well, that's too bad. Which you don't like.
Oh, she told you.
Yeah. Which meant in poetess language, you ain't paying me, bitch.
I need you know on what's that Key and Peele where he had the mad Obama. I'm going to have Kamara with me when I go places so she can be my translator.
Because I know what she's feeling all the time. anyway.
Say your shit.
My name is Kamara White.
She need a ride.
And she funny.
She's an Aries.
She's funny as fuck.
Yes, I do need a ride. But if you keep on, I don't need a ride here no more.
Oh, no.
For this show.
Yeah.
Don't punish the studio.
Show. anyway. You guys can follow me on Instagram, Facebook. Instagram is Kamara White Is. I have a show coming up, a big one, Friday at the J Spot, Saturday at the Watts Coffee House.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm
so
try to
everybody.
Come to that one.
Yeah, come through, boo.
He
get us some Watts Coffee.
Shows,
okay.
You need to add some more shows to your shit.
Yeah,
you just said that.
That's what he said.
Add some more shows.
You got extra shit.
Okay, well, I'm gonna add some more shows to my own roster. No, but I'm gonna work harder. I know what Bruce was telling me. I hear it all the time.
Rock, I noticed Rock has been keeping
well,
his eye on Kamara.
Is that you? Is that you all day long, Rock?
Do you feel something right here?
Yeah, I'm
Mr.
feeling
Wayne,
something.
His my baby birthday on his birthday. He a marine biologist. I'm a marine biologist.
Uh-oh. Wow. Kamara, is that your flavor?
I mean, I dated a Gemini. I love my baby. He born on my baby birthday. That means you got to get her good gifts. She don't play that. She a princess.
Well, Aries and Gemini is good. Gemini is air. Aries is fire.
And
both need each other.
Spread the air.
I think you got a connection.
Yeah.
Speedy, you jealous?
No. Look at Speedy got quiet.
I know, he did.
Because I'm going to call Rock when it's going down. Whatever. She's sucking dick right now? Cool.
Put her on FaceTime.
Yeah. FaceTime me, dog. FaceTime me. You imagine dude going, hey, my nigga, what you think? Dang, all you hear
I'm sure some look, this all you hear is,
hey, it's going to get good to Rock, and he ain't going to be your friend no more.
Oh.
No. Yeah. Homies be homies.
Man. I think you need to switch seats. I don't like you sitting that close to Speedy. Do he be touching you under the table?
Look.
I just play.
Go ahead, Heaven High.
Heaven High. I'm Tanji Ambrose, and I thank you for following me on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter and Pinterest. And I think a great gift to go in somebody's stocking for the Christmas season, and especially if you want to tell them about the show, is a rollout t-shirt. Right. I promise y'all, it's cute, it feels good, and they'll be really happy, and then you'll be sharing with them a piece of you, something that you love. So I'm thanking you in advance.
Yeah, like Speedy's rules.
Amazing.
Go ahead,
good sales girl.
Could you slide over? I hate this. Thank you.
Yeah, it is.
It feels weird. Yeah, I need to see your mouth.
I like it, ladies. You guys are nice.
I would like to see your mouth move. I mean, I'm sorry, Bruce. My bad.
Now you calling him Bruce.
My bad. Because I can't do Psychic Wayne. That sounds like I don't know him. Hey, Bruce.
Bruce, a little bit. Yeah, a little bit more familiar.
That's your government name.
Donations have fell off.
It is Christmas season. Niggas got options. Donate, buy the key or something.
I realize that. But if you have it, please donate to our GoFundMe.
Anything.
GoFundMe.com/Morris Media Studios. And you can find me at OG Poetess. Cool. And we just added 4 new shows.
Whoa.
I'm cool.
To Morris Media. So check MorrisMediaLive.com for our programming lineup. Why are you hating, Speedy?
I love you. The card said to hate.
No, they didn't.
You're like, not my cards.
No, I love the show. And I, love. I like your little light-skinned group.
Oh, wait. Are we still doing our potluck on the 23rd? Or no, you said you can't do because you got a show.
On that
Wednesday.
Yeah. So that's the 21st, I think.
Oh, yeah. Did y'all like my beans? We didn't get. We got a
I got
teaspoon.
Like two.
Nigga, she wouldn't share at all.
Oh. We got a teaspoon.
We came in the kitchen. Good, she went. She did like that. They're gone. She ate them all before we got in. She came in. Kamira left some beans, but wasn't that much.
She showed it.
Bring it to us first.
Too.
Don't ever set shit in that kitchen.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm over
the rest of mine.
Anyway,
we'll catch you guys back here.
And thank you, Wayne, for coming. I mean,
thank you. Come again. Come like next month because I got shit coming up.
Okay.
All right. Till Friday.
Thank you guys for having me.
Thank you.